All right, guys, welcome back. This is Cameraman, and joining me is...
Shane Dragon from Unequal Media.
What's going on, guys? Sorry about the internet outage, but we're now back with Street Fighter Cross Tekken, our most favorite game of this whole tournament.
Me, personally, I love Cross Tekken. You know, it's exciting, it's full-on, it's wacky, you know, it's fun. Let's do this, you know?
Yeah. I think just a little update. For Third Strike, if you guys have not been watching and just joined us lately, in the winner's finals is Mr. Serbian Style and EG Momochi.
EG Momochi. Now, we all know who that is.
Yes.
Definitely. The other chap, I'm not too familiar with him. Is he a... I hope he's, you know, he's an English guy. You know, he's a European.
You don't know who Momochi is?
No, no, not Momochi.
The Serbian Style?
Yes.
He beat Zach Bennett. He is definitely British. I think he's from UK.
Okay.
Maybe Welsh. I'm not sure.
All right. See, I've got quite a lot of knowledge of the UK, London players.
Okay.
But of course, the talent in the UK is so spread out.
Yeah.
We've got so many cities. Birmingham, Manchester, Newcastle, Sheffield. And it's small pockets, you know, in each of those places where the players are good. But travelling's hard for everyone, and big events don't happen that often. So it's very difficult to have a definitive database about the UK scene,
yes.
Unfortunately. We're getting there. London's very prominent. Mm-hmm. Manchester's quite strong, and Birmingham is noticeable. The other regions, it's harder to work out who's really good. But they're here today, so let's see what they've got, you know?
I played James Brown in Third Strike or Street Fighter.
Was it Street Fighter 2?
I think Street Fighter 2.
HGX. He's a veteran at Street Fighter 2. Dirty Bison, you know, it's
He was using Ryu. Actually.
He was.
Yeah, it was kind of strange.
He's a bit OG, you know. He's been playing in the arcade scene when there was an arcade scene in London. It was very vibrant about 15 years ago. James Brown's one of the guys that I met, and he's a strong competitor, and he's still doing it 15 years later.
Wow.
I say, but I know him from the Hyper Anniversary Edition of Street Fighter. He picks C.E. Bison, does the cross-up cycle crusher, and doesn't care.
Yeah.
He'll get booed off stage as long as he wins.
Well, most people can't... It's really hard to punish the cycle crusher as it comes to you.
It is.
Yep.
But I know I haven't seen him on Cross Tekken, so let's see what he's got. Picking a traditional Street Fighter team.
Jack X is a very popular character that people use. Game Movie uses it. I think... Tokido used it for a while.
Alien uses him. There's a few other guys in Europe that use Jack X.
Yeah.
Kungsto was using him, I think, as well.
Yeah, he has a lot of that move. The ground hitting move is really good. And his super is almost close to 1-2 frames.
Yes, definitely.
So it's a really, really good super that he has. It's a lot of ground control as well. But it looks like he's in trouble right now. He needs to really tag out. Oh, that was his chance right there, but he didn't take it. And now he's on the ropes.
He should have got out. Oh.
Wow, he got lucky there.
Now he's got to get an escape.
Okay.
That Ogre, you know, great trickster. Don't let him get going. I'm not sure about that.
Just random. He could have gone for the counter instead of just doing the super. During a block string, just press forward and then Fierce and Roundhouse at the same time. That would have been a better out instead of what he did just now.
Possibly.
Oh, combo time.
Good boost combo.
All right, here's a good chance. Oh, does nothing. Thought he should have continued with the pressure.
Now let's see if Jack can keep him out. Good zoning. Oh, he's a bit impatient though.
Oh, I feel nice like Starkiller is just randomly doing moves right now.
Maybe he is. Thing is, I look at the team, Ogre, Jack Cross, and I think that's good synergy, you know? You got Ogre up close, who's a headache, mm-hmm. and you got Jack to keep the distance.
Yes.
So I think that's a very strong team combination, but right now, Starkiller Shane isn't, you know, utilising that potential.
Yes.
Maybe he's getting warmed up.
I think he should just keep on using the ground-pounding pressure.
Oh, definitely. And when he gets close, just use the uppercut, keep him at bay.
Yep.
Oh, he needs to punish those flash kicks that...
Not much footsies from Starkiller right now. All he does is been mashing moves after move after move.
Yeah, definitely.
And that's nothing there. James, kind of strange.
I'm not sure. I'm James Brown, or his other nickname is Random Hajjal, using very solid Street Fighter 2 fundamentals.
Yes.
You know, I don't think he plays Cross Tekken that much, so I think, but you know, strong basics will get you through. It is about Oh, in the corner. Don't want to be there.
Yeah. It looks like both players here don't really play Street Fighter Cross Tekken much, because you can tell that they're not maximizing the combos, and it's not a lot of, you know, there's a lot of potential that you can do, especially linking jab into strong, into fierce.
Yes.
And then tagging out, but they have not done that yet, and they've just been relying on, it's like playing Street Fighter 4 right now. Wow! They Sonic Boom just...
just came out of nowhere. Invisible Sonic Boom! Oh, with random tag.
Another time over?
Oh, wow. Please don't.
This is cross Tekken right now.
Oh, I don't want a double T.
No, I think... Yeah, it is.
Oh, good flash kick.
Starkiller is losing in life lead, so he better make something happen right now. Oh, that was his chance, but...
Wow.
He wasn't able to do it. Wah, wah.
And James Brown wins that game with two timeouts. Legitimate.
legitimate.
At the moment.
Fraudulent, I think.
I'm being gentle about it. Hopefully there'll be less timeouts on the 2013 update, which I'm looking forward to.
Yes, I saw Doctanian installing some of the updates, and it looks pretty good. One of the main differences, you can tell, there's the 2013 update, is that the life
is red. Now red, yes. Yeah. The traditional red energy, which we're very used to talking about, which we call grey life now.
Yep.
So also, when Kazuya does Wind Electric Godfist, his whole body turns purple, so you can see it more.
Okay.
Rather than, it was very hard to notice.
Yep. And I really like Ionos and Capcom specifically making all these new changes, because it really got me hyped to play the game again. And I think I can't wait for the new changes to drop, and I think it will be a really good, exciting new year with the new changes.
Definitely. Well, I think it's a good gesture from Capcom. Yep. Is that it's a free update, so there's no complaining there. You know, you just get the update. It's a new, you know, essentially makes the game new again, new and fresh.
Yeah.
And hopefully,
nice
anti-air super. Cinematics. last a lifetime.
Like 10 seconds. Hell yeah.
I think that's as long. No, him and Jin have probably got the longest. And Akuma.
Yeah.
Just well to go and make a cup of tea and come back. And he's still doing it.
Another time over, I think, is coming up.
Oh, please don't.
Yes, it's going to happen right now. Yep, he just did. Because there's no way.
Oh, there's no way. Unless...
Yeah. Shout outs. Well, he still has a chance to win. Yes. Just one more.
Now, Jack can operate Pandora, but I don't think he will.
I don't think...
No, I don't think he will.
There's not even time for Pandora. Because once you activate it...
Of course. You are there. If you activate it with less seconds... That Pandora, you're dead anyway, aren't you? So,
Well, it's going to be time over anyway for that one. It doesn't stop or extend the time. Wow, nice EX there. Doesn't fail to juggle.
Yeah, it doesn't capitalize on the wall bounce too much.
Whiff to grab.
And again, to everyone's ears, the grab range is increased.
Oh, really?
Yes, definitely. And you can't just throw out chains or boost combos so freely now.
I think that's a good improvement. I also noticed the time in the new series being faster. I mean, slower.
Slower.
So there's less timeouts. Unfortunately, right now, it's all timeouts so far.
I would like to see...
Oh, nice!
He doesn't capitalize on that juggle. M. Bison could have punished harder there.
That's a pretty easy combo right there that he missed.
Oh, pause the game. Now you see.
It's all right. It's all good. It's all good.
We'll disqualify a player if we did that in one of our tournaments.
Okay, but...
Well, no, he'd lose the round, more like.
Yeah. But we're here for fun.
We are definitely here for fun.
It's a gentleman's game. Just let it rock.
I've noticed that the bracket is quite full. Let's be honest, you know, the popularity of the game did disappear.
Yes.
Rather quickly. And his country as well. It's like this whole nation stopped playing this game.
Wow, really?
Yeah, really. It was really hard to find anyone doing sessions or... You know, I used to tap into event hubs to see a few streams. Even they vanished. You know, so let's hope in 2013 we'll give that energy, you know, rejuvenation that the game requires.
Shout outs to the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle shirt that Starkiller is wearing.
Retro.
The retro. Wait, back in the 90s.
Did you say Ninja Turtles or Mutant Turtles?
Ninja Turtles.
Ninja. Oh, in the UK we call it Teenage Mutant Hero Turtles.
Hero Turtles.
Hero Turtles. I don't know why.
I guess they are like the Geneva or, you know, the X-Men where they want to ban all the mutants.
Yeah.
So you put mutants.
And mutants is bad.
Are you guys having a secret Sentinel project to destroy all the mutants?
I'll have to go and ask the Prime Minister about that one. You know,
it's not an MI6.
That doesn't exist. You watch Skyfall then. It's not where you think it is.
Well, M is done, right? So they got this new guy.
You know what? I'm not going to give anything away. Skyfall was a great British movie. You know, it really does portray... You know, Bond is great anyway. I really love Daniel Craig's rendition of Bond. He's really tough. Really believable.
Oh, wow. He does nothing. I think he thought he was playing Street Fighter 4 and just tagged out right in front of Ogre.
Oh, failed Sonic Boom?
Yeah. Ooh, nice. Should have done the standing roundhouse instead.
Yeah, straight into boost combo, straight into launch.
Ooh,
oh, don't fight him.
Oh, fails to punish.
Guys, please, punish.
Punish accordingly.
Punish harder, please. Make it more entertaining.
Wow.
Oh, good flash kick. Oh!
Wow, nice. It's, looks like it's another time over.
Again.
Yes. He should definitely switch out because this is a bad matchup for Jadax right now to chase him down. But I was wrong.
Commentator's curse.
Just kept on doing the body check.
The thing is though, Jax, you're really abusing the Seismo. You know, pound. You know, just do it more. You know, Guile's not going to be able to get near him. He's going to force Guile to jump in, so he can't charge. So, you know, Jax should be able to control this battle
a lot
better.
Nice there.
Oh, good flash kick. Nice reversal.
I think James Brown has been 10 for 10 on that flash kick, wake up flash kick.
So he's playing Street Fighter 2 all day and all night.
Oh, nice frame trap there. A good rush down here by James Brown. It seems like Starkiller isn't maximizing the moves from Ogre. On full screen, he can do the Oni punch down to the ground.
Yep.
But he hasn't been doing that at all.
Also, he's not capitalizing on the air-to-air counters.
Yes.
That's where this game opens up, you know. Catch him in the air. What can you do to him? You know, keep him in the air, do a cancel dash, get underneath him. Like how Jin does it. I've seen some high-level Jin players. It's wonderful to watch how they get underneath you.
Yep.
You know, so hopefully we'll see some of that in the later stages of the tournament.
I think they are really not using the footy game. You know, M. Bison can easily just go... standing forward into roundhouse and then roundhouse
launch,
and that has never happened. I don't think he knows how to do it.
I'd say, to be honest, I don't think these guys are particularly strong. I don't think they play the game a lot. I think again because it's a fun day.
Yeah, but you know that's really 1-1 basic of Street Fighter Cross Tekken. The first thing you learn is to learn the jab, strong, fierce combo.
Yeah.
But they're not really even utilizing that. Oh, and another time over.
I'll even say that. I think that is a bit overused. Yep. That you could go through... So look at the trial. Some really intricate combos. And I think if you look at the damage output on one of those intricate combos, but then if you just do two boost combos, a boost combo into launch,
yep.
And then like, you know, like a medium punch flash kick, I think you get the same sort of damage output. So, yes. I don't know. It's like sometimes how people play it makes the game a bit dull sometimes.
But I think there's a lot of... footsie games right now and a lot of combos that are really nice to look at, and I think he has failed to capitalize on that. Like he's using a grab to punish a whiff. That's not what you should do in Street Fighter Cross Tekken.
No.
Should make maximize the damage,
you know, the average, you know, hit.
Ooh, nice. Ooh. That's totally ST move right there.
He is. He's very ST James Brown. No, but he's an excellent ST player. He really truly is.
Yes, he is.
I'm not sure how far he came earlier, but I'm sure he did very well.
I think he's still in the tournament because they haven't ran the loser's bracket
yet. Right.
And I think he's in winner's bracket right now.
So he's definitely multitasking at the moment.
Yes.
Two games at once.
Ooh. Oh. Another white grab. Grab is the least damage in this whole game.
Oh, there it is. There it is.
That's what I'm talking about.
Finally.
Oh, where's the flash kick?
Where's the flash kick?
Why did you do the sonic boom? Oh.
And I'm going to go over there, give him a 101 on... Street Fighter Cross Tekken.
All right, looks like James Brown's going to win this. He's going to feel good.
Just do Sonic Hurricane. Oh. And a very stylish, normal grab from... That's not very nice, that grab from...
Why did James Brown not switch out? He would have won, but now he lost. Loser bracket time, James Brown. the Godfather of Soul.
When I first met him, I thought he was joking.
Is his name really James Brown?
His name is actually James Brown. And he doesn't hide it. He's very proud of it. Every time, I feel good. He's getting bored of it though now.
No, I don't think he can get bored. Does he do the ha?
Well, he's not as dark as James Brown. I don't think he's got, the soul isn't quite there.
You don't need to be dark like James Brown. You just have his confidence, his style. That's all you need, right?
He's one of a kind. I must have been watching Rocky 2.
Yeah.
And I think Apollo comes down a lift.
Uh-huh.
And she's James Brown, the real James Brown. There's no actor there.
Yeah.
There's no stage double. It was the
you
real
see
James
Coming
Brown.
To America, right?
Yeah. Oh, I was loving that. In the living room. Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah. Anyway, we've been trying to find out, what is this thing?
Okay, let me it's
what's
the,
this thing called?
Right. Oh, I should know this. I live in London the whole of my life.
It's a hat.
It's
a hat.
Me and Doug Tenney were discussing it earlier, and it's not a beef eater. It's
It sounds like a beef. Yeah. Why is it called a beef eater? What's a beef eater?
I don't think it's about eating beef. I don't think it's. Oh, you know, you put me on the spot now, Kevin. Thanks a lot. That's a changing of the guard, and basically.
Yes, I'm aware of that.
It's a big wig, big hat, big.
I know it's a big hat.
Oh, you know more
than
me.
It's a big wig.
Oh.
What is it?
It's
what's the official name? The HRH is going to be mad.
Can I consult my friend Google quickly? I've forgotten.
Sorry.
When we're young, we go and see all these attractions.
Uh-huh.
And then when we get older, I'm in my 30s, we don't really care about this anymore.
Oh, okay.
Not really. So maybe someone in the stream can help me a little.
I would like to shout out to DJ Logan, a very famous DJ.
He is.
In London.
He does the grime circuit. Now, it's not everyone's favorite music.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's our equivalent to, like, hip-hop. But you know what? Every Monday night, I'm going to plug DJ Logan.
I love hip-hop.
You know, it's the grime sessions. He gets down with the likes of JME, Skepta, I forget their names now. Wiley. You know, every Monday night, 12 to 1. Kiss 100, DJ Logan Sama, and this is his secondary job. And
yes,
he's
a very good commentator. He's working really hard to run the Bearcats right now. Shout outs to him. It looks like it's a huge community effort out here for everybody involved in the UK FGC.
Without a doubt, you know, there are a couple of, and obviously it's Arms House, which is very noticeable.
Yep.
For the UK, well, it's for the UK, it's very noticeable because we're so small and. Logan is the host of Winner Stays On every Tuesday.
Yes.
Alternates between Street Fighter Marvel and down in London. And,
Where is Winner Stays On?
It is based in Gamer Base, which is inside an HMV store. Inside
HMV?
Yeah, inside the Trocadero.
How do you guys get a spot like that?
Because there was a chap called Sudroy who developed the Gamer Base Center. HMV bought it from him.
And, okay, wow.
But there was five or six Gamer Bases, and not so many now, and it's like a physical outlet for the UK players to go to. And the London Gamer Base is legendary, like, you know, they've got Arms House, Big Up, Worskeef and Logan, and we all get in there and do little things, you know, once a week. It's good fun. Every London guys, Gamer Base every night of the week, you know.
It was a good choice for Huddle Shrooms to switch out Ryu, because Zangief wasn't able to get in, but maybe he wants to switch in Zangief right now against Jack X so that he can get more of the footsie games in.
Yeah, definitely. Now, Huddle Shrooms is a Zangief man. Every game, Zangief, without a doubt. So I didn't know who his second character was in this game.
But I think he's just taking Ryu right now. Wow, just let it go.
You can't go wrong with Ryu sometimes, can you? So
how do you pronounce this guy's name? Quaker?
That was Quaker, King Quaker.
Cool.
Again, another strong London player. He regularly travels. You see him in Paris, Bushido Impact.
Oh, Punish there.
Oh, good SPD.
All right, set up.
Oh, Jad, but did not capitalize. Good reversal.
Oh, nice sweep.
Oh, styling from Quaker. Is he going to maximize this?
No.
Oh, again, Quaker's not utilizing, you know, the size mode as much as I think he should. And in Jack's exceptionally long
move.
Oh, no one gets caught by the Bear Crusher. I'm sorry.
That's a good Bear Crusher, though. It has armor in this.
Oh,
one,
yeah,
so
you know.
Much better.
Just jump over it, I assume. Yep. Don't jump away. You'll take the damage. Take the armor.
Oh, it's done. Time's out.
Oh, another timeout. Shouts out to Glorious Timeouts.
I think we've seen a lot of timeouts today.
I think in the early stages of this, this tournament, we're going to see timeouts.
I think most players have been really passive, and there's not a lot of damaging combos in the start. Like this one-hit stuff that really doesn't really do a lot of damage. But, I mean, if you play Infiltration and Mago or Tokido...
They're in your face. Yeah. Switch it in and out. I'd say Infiltration has got it worked out that, you know, his characters don't go underneath, what, 70% energy?
Yes.
Because he's constantly getting them out, you know, constantly getting regaining health, which is, you know, obviously nerfed a lot in 2013 edition. But definitely Infiltration worked out this game, how to keep his characters in and alive.
I would like to see Quaker do more combos. Ooh, oh, drop the level.
You know what? I bet guarantee Quaker's kicking himself. That didn't connect.
Yeah. I mean, when he tags in with Jack Axe, instead of doing a punch, a rocket punch, he can easily just do jab into medium punch, into heavy punch. Just to get damage.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Or even maybe, you know, just, well, not launch again, obviously, because Jim will come straight back in again. But, yeah. Now, as I said, it's really hard to work out who's good. Now, Quaker, when the game first came out, Doctanian teamed up with myself and my team on Equal Media. We did a Monday night event in Gamer Base every Monday. Mm-hmm. And we had some pretty good numbers when the game first came out. We were getting like over 32. But I think people were getting bored straight away of the game.
Oh, wow, that was nice.
Strong lariat.
I was surprised that when Jin neutral jump, he didn't do the lariat. He did it like a little later, so it was a delayed reaction, but he got it anyway.
We call it sinking.
Sinking.
Like you sink the dragon punch, you sink.
So many terms.
Sink the lariat. And then like we London slang for SBD, you scoop.
Yep.
Man got scooped.
Scooped?
Scooped. That's what it is, isn't it? Like
Is that from Marvel?
No, it's like back in the day saying, like, a good 10 years ago.
Okay.
And I'm going to big up Ryan Hart because he had this lingo from back in the day. We used to, and one of his, when you do a combo which is extended or you may mix up a move, so you might put a jab in rather than put a short. Uh-huh. He calls it jelly beans.
Why?
Because it's just mixed up, you know?
Okay.
You open a bag of jelly beans, you're different colours. So, you know, a guy called Bulletproof and Ryan Hart came up with the word jelly beans. And we used to use it a lot back in the arcade days. Even a lot of these new school guys wouldn't know what jelly beans are. They think it's like, a bag of sweets. But, you know, big up to all those guys. Shout out to being over 30 and playing fighting games. Jelly beans.
All right, that was round two. There's a huge change in characters.
Quaker has got a lot of characters under his belt. He's gone through a lot of the class.
Ooh, drops the combo there.
But, you know, he did start with Relento. And, this team, you know, he's strong with his team. You'll definitely see a difference now in his gameplay.
Yes, he's definitely... I don't know why he picked the first team that he played with, because this is definitely a whole different player right now.
He's very comfortable with it. It's one of his original teams. Yep. Oh, nice launch.
That's the end.
Oh, you know what? Just get down to business. Punch into Godfist.
This is the kind of gameplay that I came to watch.
Yeah, it's fast, you know? So it's, you know, this game
combos.
Is... This game is exciting. This game is high, you know, high pace. It's rapid. You know, that's your choice, how you want to play it, you know?
Cross up. Oh.
Oh, we see this time he just didn't push any buttons. Yes.
Wow.
Great combo for my Archie. Puts in a very good position now. Good cross up. No. Gets kicked away. My mistake.
Oh, didn't feel to punish this tag out. For some reason, I don't know why Hado Shrooms tagged out Zangief, because it would have been a good matchup for... Hayachi, because you know,
ooh, nice
Hayachi really
combo.
Has to get in, and Zangief is a good character against characters that need to get in.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, corner shenanigans.
Okay, high low mix up. Nope, just a jump.
Ooh,
in
jumps out. Here we go. Here comes the... Oh no. Ooh. Quaker should have done that. Should have gone for the low hit.
Yeah, I think he was trying to end the game right there.
But you know about Hayachi, once he puts a finger on you, that's 13 glorious hits. So let's see if Quaker can deliver some magic.
Yeah, Hado
ooh, mixed
Shrooms.
Up. Ooh.
It's just randomly trying to grab him right now, but... Ooh.
Again, keeping the combo nice and simple. Good damage, though.
I think he's got this. He just needs to waste more time. And he's got a...
But I was going to say, I think he can outright kill Zangief from this, this point.
Or just play it safe and try to get a timeout. There's no reason for him to get in right now. He can sit there and block all day.
Ooh, I'm not quite sure what Hutchins is doing that, you know?
He basically gave up because...
I guess he did. Yeah.
So a little short update on Mago. So Mago missed his flight yesterday.
Oh.
And
Really? So he's not here at all?
He's on his way. He took the train from Heathrow and he's on his way here. And it takes about 5 hours.
The PIDA, with all considering all the changes and getting to the major stations to get up here and all the connections. Oh, nice boost combo. Oh, yep. Punch, God Fist, punch, spinning uppercut. Oh, here comes big combo. Punch, God Fist. Oh, no. Styling in the corner.
We got combos now.
Oh, nice Patriot. Oh, all the hits of Patriot Circle. I guess it's because Zangief's got a big hitbox, I suppose that works. Oh, good anti-air. Nice. You know, I used to love that move in Alpha 2, you know. Abuse it. Medium pogo.
Oh, he drops the combo.
Oh,
there, but
bad time to throw Hadouken.
So much pressure just from the jab.
I mean, I don't like playing Olento. It really does put you on a lot of pressure. You know, all you got to do is, you know, poof and you shouldn't, or push a button and he kind of hits you and then...
Oh, nice tech there. Almost nobody techs now in this game.
No, you never see any throws.
No, you see a lot of throws because you don't want to get caught in a frame trap. Because once you get caught in a frame trap, the damage is way more than, you know, just getting a throw. Throw is not that much of a damage.
So in this game, take the throw. It's a much better option, isn't it?
Yeah. But, you know, only in high level you see people really tech. But, you know, in these type of games right here, nobody really techs right now.
Again, Kraker keeping it, you know, strong and basic, you know. I know Hachi's got a lot of potential.
I don't think Hayachi is winning. This is so close.
I can't tell.
Maybe
just by the skin of his teeth.
Ooh, nice cross-up.
Nice cross-up. Full page of circle combo. Cross-up again. Oh, nice counter-reversal.
Yep. I don't think Infiltration going into the finals will change his team from Rolento Ryu, but I'm pretty sure Tokido, who qualified in Brazil, is going to have a lot of tricks. He's been hiding in his room every day training, and I think it's going to be a really exciting finals.
Was he using Dalsim Cody? Was that him?
Yes,
he was, wasn't it?
But he's going to learn. He's going to show you guys something new because
he's always
got something up his sleeve.
We do have a couple of, you know, strong cross Tekken players. We've got Taha, obviously Ryan Hart. He did quite well when he was, you know, when he went to Cross Assault, and obviously playing our Monday nights, he won it a few times. Actually.
Ooh. All right, Hadouche Rooms definitely have to make something happen right now, and not just play passive because he's in danger of that happening right now.
I don't think you want to really wait with Rolento, do you? You want to try and apply pressure to him before he applies it on you.
Yes,
without doubt.
And his footsie is so good. All right, 24 seconds left before Quaker takes this match. Ooh, nice anti-air there.
Nice lariat. Oh, failed conversion.
Could have been it there. Nice body press from Zangief. Oh, I think Quaker knows that he could let that one slip away. And now it's match point. Final round, final game for both players.
I have to say, I don't see him abusing the standing hard punch. You know, and massive range on that move.
Yes.
And obviously cancelable into gentle launch as well.
Yes, but I think he's more afraid of Zangief's jump in. And one jump in from Zangief is a lot of damage.
It is quite scary.
Oh, failed the
anti-air
there.
Oh, again, he didn't confirm the combo. Risky switch.
Wow, it's switch again?
Maybe that's accidental, maybe. I don't know.
That's definitely Street Fighter 4 in effect because I think he's trying to focus.
Maybe he is.
Oh! What? What is going on?
Hello, I'm disappointed. This game is so easy to get a combo.
Yes.
It's not hard, it's four buttons.
You shouldn't be dropping any combos right now. I think they're all very nervous.
Possibly. As soon as you see a jab connect, the easiest combo in the world. Guys, come on.
Oh, nice uppercut trade there.
Oh, failed grab. Oh, happy birthday.
Yep. but just one hit.
Yeah, just.
Oh, that was a terrible.
Here we
switch.
Go, Hayachi. Rev it up, turn it on. Oh, missed a hard punch.
Oh, that fails to convert. Oh, grab him. I don't think he knows that was just a block move.
Low moves only, nice. Isn't it?
Oh, looks like Hado Strooms might win it. Wow, oh, he does.
No, wait.
No, he does, Life Lead.
No, he did.
Yes. Hado Strooms winning.
That's a shame. I thought Quaker's strong, you know, and I thought he wouldn't be dropping to losers. Oh, wow.
Yes, Hado Strooms just came over and said, I just won a game that I haven't played in 7 months.
Basically, he won a game you don't play against someone who actively plays this game. Anyway, I'm not going to go into that conversation.
I should have been playing this game.
I wanted to.
Today, I'm commentating.
I wanted to play this game today, but today, we're doing the best job in the world, aren't we, Kip?
I love you guys. Shout outs to Hans.
Oh, yeah.
The best streamer in the world, next to Spooky.
Finally met the legendary Hans. He's a bit, you know what? He's such a.
All right, wait.
He's looking at me. No, let's say he's such a humble fella. You know? He doesn't let the fame. If it was me, oh, Hans, you would see I'd have a statue of myself. Every city I stream in. And I do an excellent job, you know. I tune in regularly.
Your nose is getting browner and browner.
Oh, you know.
But anyway.
It's all about community relationships, you know.
So, update on Mago. So, the train, me and Z speak English.
Oh,
and taking the train from London to
Birmingham.
Houston,
London to Houston, Houston to Birmingham.
Birmingham
to Telford. And we're having to walk.
It's extremely difficult and really hard because, you know, you need to ask people for directions and you speak English, right? Mago does not speak English. So, I don't know how he's going to get here. I think a lot of people are going to be happy. I think Reinhardt's going to be happy. Momochi's going to be happy. Z is going to think he has a chance. Zach Bennett is going to have a chance.
He's going to wipe his brow.
F word.
He's just going to like wipe his brow.
Yes. Everyone is hoping that the GPS on Mago fails. But I hope he's safe. I think Mago is very well traveled.
I know. For me personally, going to another country and having to deal with their transport system, it can be very overwhelming. Is he traveling solo as well?
Yes, I think so. Wow. But it's kind of, if you speak English or you travel a lot, it's actually quite easy. I've traveled a lot anyway. And especially if you travel in Europe, it's quite easy too.
Yeah, you need to get used to it.
It's not really that hard, but just asking for simple directions. And they don't really put signs to say Telford. It says something else.
No, you're right. It only when you get nearer. Because Telford is not a major city. I didn't know about Telford until I started doing the iSeries about a year ago. So even I, who lives in this country the whole of his life.
You guys have a huge mall here. It's a really nice city. I think they have Staples, which is a huge franchise from America.
Staples isn't that big in this country, you know.
But they even made the investment to open the Staples here.
We have, you know, massive hypermarkets, we call them.
Yep.
We've got a Trafford Centre, which is the size of like three soccer pitches. I'll say soccer because it's international views. It's like five soccer pitches
you can
in
say
there.
Football, it's fine.
I'll say football. And then we've got Westfield in West London near where I live.
I like Westfield.
And
there's a lot of Westfields in San Francisco and in the East Coast and West Coast as well.
Oh, so it's not a British brand then?
It's a chain, yeah.
Oh, okay. No, our first Westfield, when you walk in the main entrance, you hit, I don't know if it's the same with your one, you hit the, what's it called? The gallery or something? Really expensive shops. Louis Vuitton, Dior, you know, Prada stores.
It sounds so regal coming up from your British accent. Louis Vuitton.
Oh.
You know, with the British, it sounds so classy, just like Dudley.
Oh, this fine. Like, gentlemen, excuse me, hold my gloves while I have a cup of tea. You know,
it's, a spot of tea, right?
You know, the British accents of, you know, Steve, it's in this game, Steve, Cammy, and Dudley, they're a bit overdone, but like Elizabeth Hurley talked about that.
Actually, I don't feel like Cammy has a really British accent, like, to be honest.
Damn, drat, that didn't work, did it?
Yeah,
it's kind of like a moany woman, you know. It is British. It is English, but
she sounds very sexy. I like Cammy's voice.
But it's funny because I live in northwest London. The very northwest of London.
Uh-huh.
And then I talk totally different to a guy that live in South London, and they call me posh. It's like, listen, I'm a Londoner, mate. What are you talking about? Posh, Cockney.
I thought I thought you were going to tell me that you really know a real life Cammy that looks like Cammy.
That'd be stupid. That's how we go into
That's
Japan.
What I thought you were going to tell no, me, but you're going to tell me about no. accents. I'm like, what?
Oh, yeah, I invited Dudley around for tea the other day. He didn't take his gloves off either. Okay.
Okay.
He didn't.
But speaking of which, I was at DreamHack, and I can tell you that the Swedish women in DreamHack all look like Cammy.
Are you talking about the physique as well?
Everything, yes.
They are.
And it's amazing. I've never seen that many Cammies in the world gather in one gaming event. And the ratio from guys to girls is at least 40-60. 40% girls, 60% guys. It's amazing.
Everyone says that, you know, the European flavor of women. Like, my friend comes from Estonia and he goes, yes. The women in Estonia, I miss the women. It's like, Dimitri, come on, you know, if you miss them, why did you move to this country? You know, it's like women make the world go around. I said it, you know, women, money, cars, you know, and Street Fighter, you know.
Video games.
Video games.
Shout outs.
Know. Shout outs. A life in video games.
There's so many. Yeah. All right. To tell you the truth, there's not many females here. This looks like a regular Street gaming convention.
All right.
But when you go to DreamHack, it's just mind-blowing.
Is it? But is it the promotional girls, or is it female gamers? Which one is it?
It's female gamers, because we went from station to station, and literally, there are so many female gamers there. It's the highest concentration of female gamers I've ever seen. And I'm not lying to you. Because you can watch our videos on madcast.com.
Yep.
And you can see, like, it's just girls playing video games.
Wow, that is... I've only met, like, three or four. There was a female gamer here, Sam Whale. She used to play for Team Dignitas a couple of years ago.
Wow, yes. Arisno is using Elisa.
Wow.
A character that we never see.
Yeah, Undiscovered Tech. That's the thing. You know, all the DLC characters came out, and then the game's popularity died. So if you master, I reckon Lei. I reckon a Lei player will destroy everyone.
Wait. Arisno is definitely going to win this, because... He plays this game. Wow, that's really, really good.
And again, he's, you know, Julia's mix-up, you know, the overheads which don't look like overheads, you know.
Yep.
I call it the dance, you know, very strong. And then, like, if you can extend the combos and carry the links on, you just go sit there and let her finish. Yep. It's like X-Factor, really.
Wow, great overhead right there.
Oh, nice link combo. Oh, switch combo in the corner. Wow, great finish. Oh, you know
in
what?
In the front this time.
Ambiguous, like it's going to go over, but... Wow, this guy's definitely... Now, this is what we're talking about. This is Cross Tekken.
Yes. That's really good rush down there from Arisno right now. There's no chance that Starkiller Shane's going to win this.
No.
We saw him play just now.
Exactly. No disrespect to the guy, but I think we definitely picked up one of the pros, one of the, you know, top guys.
Yeah, we're pretty far along in the brackets now, so we're definitely going to see more of these type of more high-level play.
I was saying earlier, you know, there's 44 guys in a 64-man bracket,
yep.
Which is not bad for this game. I think maybe 10 or 12.
Ooh, nice cross up there.
Wow. Oh, continue the extended combos.
Just walk up, grab.
Yeah, got him scared. Wow. There's that Yun-style lunge punch.
And Arisno takes the first game. I think Starkiller Shane is a little shell-shocked.
Actually, he's not British. Talking to him earlier. He's from Central Europe. I'm not quite sure where, but
He's infiltrated the British ranks.
Can we use that word anymore? In its original, you know, in its original form now.
Yes, we can.
We can.
We use the king, Queen's English, right? Is it Queen's or King?
The Queen's English.
Yes,
we are. So he got infiltrated.
Yes, I saw the Queen the other day, and she looks very healthy.
You know what? For an older chick, I shouldn't say that.
No,
she's well
look after.
She's definitely, you know, the monarchy is very strong in this country, yes. And she's definitely the figurehead.
Yes,
and she will not pass on the reins to Charles. I don't think she trusts him.
I don't know about that, but
that's politics. I should not get into on the stream.
I don't know anything about the British politics, so. But it looks like Starkiller Shane was doing well, but
it was a good start. But
Arisno is just
wow. There he goes at. That
overwhelming
tech.
Wow, stalling right now, showing the viewers at home how this game is being played. I don't think a raw tech there by Starkiller Shane was advisable.
I think he's generally quite worried, so you know, with tech like this, you don't really want to be up close with Julia.
Yes.
So you just get them out, I suppose. You know, it does give them some distance.
Yeah, you got to give credit to Starkiller Shane. He's really putting in an effort.
He is. That was a good anti-air.
He knows he's being outclassed right now, but he's still really trying his best to make the best out of it and try to win.
Oh, good boost into launch. Nice EX finish. Oh, drops low sweep.
Oh, cool. Wake up upcut there.
Those cheeky, a few of the Tekken girls have got cross-ups that are punches.
Oh.
Which are very, very ambiguous. You know, you don't usually see a cross-up medium punch.
Yeah.
And I think Elisa's got the same sort of thing.
Wow, just wake up.
Lucky. Too many startup frames, I suppose.
Wow, nice armor dash EX move.
Was that alpha counter or was that just anticipated?
That was just he just did it and it just so happened that the armor absorbed the seismo.
Right,
and then
sure.
He just... Wow, raw tech in the face.
Yeah, that close? Come on, mate. You need to back up a bit.
I don't think they know about the alpha counter.
No, I don't. A lot of people don't use it as much as they should, you know, and it's...
Well, when you see like getting frame trap and stuff, or you know trying to do a safe tag in, you'll see more of that alpha counter. When you watch the other finals, like the one in Taiwan, where it was Punko versus Infiltration,
right.
You'll see him use a lot of alpha counters.
And I guess alpha counter to switch and opens up,
yep.
You know, into a big combo. So no, it's definitely worth spending 2 bars sometimes. You know,
yes.
Your result might be. You know, worth the risk. But, well, that was a clean match from...
Yep, Arizono taking it easily from Starkiller Shane. I guess he's going to move on to the winners from his pool.
I guess
so everybody, what they're doing now, what Logan is doing for the brackets right now is they're going to run pools just like EVO, but they're only going to run all the winners.
Yes.
So most of the people right now are just playing winners bracket. And then they're going to move on to the loser's bracket after that.
And where can the guys on stream catch the brackets into challenge.com/...
Just go to challenge.com.
Last call. Right, we lose the bracket, wherever you are.
SFXTK.
Wow, that's quite long.
SFXT. So it's challenge.com/...
You forgot already.
No. SF25UK
SFXT.
So everybody, I'm sure Hans is going to type it on stream right now. You guys can go and check it out there. The easiest way to do that for challenge is you go to challenge and then on the bottom left there's publish tournaments.
Right, sure.
And just hit the publish tournaments and you can see the results, see all the tournaments there,
okay.
As well, and you can find it there. So there's several ways of doing it. I think that's the easiest way for me because, you know, remembering the URL was kind of hard.
Yeah, and that was a particularly long one as well. So,
yeah.
I'm new to challenge. We started to use it recently.
Yes.
And so that's why I didn't know to, you know, mention that shortcut. But definitely.
I like the new TIO right now that they have released. They've added a few new features and stuff, and it's really, really good.
Cool.
Yeah,
so we have to check it out and take more notice of it. You know, because
we
used to do brackets the old-fashioned way for many years, and human error does happen. And you know,
no, I think EVO. Have you been to EVO before?
I went in 2008. So yes,
okay. They still use even this year. They're still using paper.
Really?
They don't have challenge. They don't have anything. Everyone is still using paper. I think it's still the best way to run a huge tournament like that with thousands of people playing. That's the easiest using. Challenge is great for a smaller scale tournament, but for EVO, a tournament that size, it's almost impossible to do a challenge right now. Just the sheer amount of computers and people required to use.
Linking and networking and all sorts of liaison you have to do with so many of those.
Yes. And I would like to give a shout out to Mad Cats. Although I know you guys are always supporting Mad Cats, but I think a lot of the events here are sponsored by them.
You know what, Mad Cats UK...
What have they done for you?
For
let's
us?
Tell me.
Right, basically, Mad Cats, they supply joysticks, prize support to a lot of small tournaments, the large tournaments.
How many sticks did they give you? I want to know, because
I
saw so many
right
there.
I think Mad Cats, big up Rachel and Alex, must have, from the beginning of the year, given away about 500 sticks. And we're talking...
500?
Yes, you know, they gave...
Wow.
A ridiculous amount. You know, they shipped out loads to Capcom... you know, yeah, about almost 100 sticks to Capcom, PS3, Xbox, Cross Tekken. You've got the MLG stick lying around, you know, and that's just, you know, been fighting games. I mean, in the Insomnia Hall, Mad Cat's logo's everywhere. So the pro pads are to my right.
Yes.
And Mad Cat's support us so much in this country.
That's like, amazing.
We've got, you know, we must have between these, you know, this section here, the Capcom section, and Unequal Media section, or the fighting game section of this event, there must be, what, 60 or 70 heads, 60 headsets, two per setup. You know, for optimal sound, we've got Kunai's for the PlayStation, and we've got detonators on the 360. Basically, player two is WSO AFI. I think so. And the first guy I'm not too familiar with, but AFI's quite strong at this game, you know. He's another strong Street Fighter 4 player. He's quite well known if you catch the Arms House stream on Tuesday nights.
Yes.
You know, guy or player, DJ player now. Well, I think, you know, I'll say he's like the UK's best DJ. You know, very strong, great combos. He also has got
Guy, I think there's only one famous DJ player right now, and that's Afro Cole from Seattle.
Sure.
I don't know if you heard of him. He's a legendary. He's a legend.
There are so many American players that I can't keep up sometimes. I'm very interested in the, you know, UK guys as well. So it's, you know, shame on me sometimes not keeping up, but
this guy's been around. He's an ST player.
Yes.
He's a great Street Fighter 4 player. He was in the Street Fighter 4 finals, the national tournament in the finals. He plays, he calls it a trifecta of black power because he plays DJ,
yep,
Dalsim, and Balrog.
So he's keeping it real. Fight the power.
He doesn't play Dudley though.
But Dudley's actually Asian, I heard.
Okay.
Of really? Some Indian descent. Straight hair and dark skin.
Yes,
and you know,
yes.
Sometimes the illustrations, he's lighter. He's not so dark. So okay. I think it's based around... No. He's based around a Indian boxer, I heard. I could be completely wrong. That's what I heard. So that's why he's not necessarily... Well, how many black guys look like that and talk like that? Let's be honest now.
Yes.
And I'm supposed to be quite
posh. But, you know...
And I don't talk that way.
I think he has a really good team going on, and he's a really good player, Afro Cole, and he really helps out his community and his scene up in Seattle, and he's been trying to do a lot of good things for the community. He's been around for a long time. All right, Technic versus WSO.
Technic, WSO, AFI. And... And I like what Afi is that he's got a very strong Street Fighter 4.
Wow, right there. Look at those combos.
And he's got the dash loop, which has been nerfed a bit, but you know.
Ooh, nice cross up. I mean, no, overhead.
Yep, strong. Flash. Oh no, saves the flash kick.
Woohoo. Now, Juri is one of the underused characters. She could have easily anti-air there. And she has a really good anti-air that can actually combo into a flop. A ground bounce into a super. So she's actually a really, really strong character. But technique. Didn't have the technique. And sorry, I had to do it.
You set out there like that.
I'm sorry, I had to do it.
Shout out to Kevin.
And you could have easily just done a juggle off the anti-air. That's why it's very dangerous to jump in on Juri in this game. I think he should switch out, but...
Wow, standing medium kick and sea air. As you can see, someone knows Guile rather well. But no, Afi's been using Guile ever since...
I think that move has been around for about 25 years.
Oh, yeah,
years.
It has, isn't it? It might look a little different.
20 years.
We used to think we call it the mule kick.
Yes.
No, that's the upside down kick. Oh, I don't know. I can't remember.
Just jumping in, Juri.
Risky business. Jumping into Guile of all people, Mr. Anti-Air.
Yes. Well, his anti-air here is not as good as in Street Fighter.
Oh, nice standing hard kick. Oh, here comes a good conversion.
This Juri does not do any anti-airs. Wow. Ooh, drops the combo. A little too early. Lots of shenanigans from Raven. Doesn't fool Juri. Oh, wow. Just raw tag. What's going on with all these raw tags? Wow, nice.
I said earlier, you know, people have sort of fallen out of love with this game, so I don't think a lot of guys have practiced as much as they should have for this event. I think they're just going on their muscle memory and what they used to do.
Yeah.
So, you know, they're slightly out of time. Their timing's slightly off. Oh, that's a nice EX
Technique
star.
Is feeling himself. Just wasted all three bars for level three.
See, if that was Street Fighter, it's, you know, it's four parts, isn't it? We call that Kit Kat.
Yep.
It's four bars. Wasted, anyway. That's a, do you have Kit Kat in Singapore?
Yes.
Yes. So you do.
We're very British. We have everything you got.
Cool. Have you got Ribena though? I bet you haven't got Ribena.
Yes.
My daughter
loves drinking Ribena.
Oh, I'm coming to Singapore because they haven't got Ribena in America.
We're part of the colony.
Of course.
You have to understand that. Our plugs and switches are all the same.
Driving the same side of the road.
Yeah, everything is the same.
I'm emigrating. I'm gonna come live with you.
No.
Come on, throw the wife out.
I think you should stay here and boost your community. You're such an important community member. All right, Effie just took the first game, and now on to the second game, which I think Technique is overwhelmed. He's not been anti-airing Gao's jump in. It's just a down. It's just one button. It's really easy. He's not been doing it.
Down hard punch, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Or medium.
And yeah, of course, it creates struggle state as well. Now I remember. Yes, I do.
And then you just jump and roundhouse.
Has she got that ground? Yeah, you just said this. It's amazing. Wasn't listening. Wow, there you go. The cheeky shenanigans from Raven.
Every time you see a dash or anything, just mash on the light punch. Ooh, just raw tag. Wow, nice juggle there. Drops the combo.
Oh,
nice
stand
raw grab. Nice grab. Chun-Li didn't get it come in. Still full health.
I think Affy's now, you know, getting back into his mode. You know, so nice boost combo. Oh, he's dropping the loop. Oh, is that overhead?
Oh, nice. Ground bounce.
Wow, lovely stuff.
Do they call it OTG here SFX Tekken as well?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. I'm going to use OTG from now on, FGC terms. Oh, nice.
Nice cut. Oh,
combo.
That jab pressure.
Oh, why didn't he connect into a combo there?
Wow, dash cancelled.
OTG.
Oh, you know what? He should have punished low sweep there.
A good tag there, just to play it safe. Now Gao coming in with full life, full health.
Doing what Gao does best. Ooh.
Wow.
Now if it's anybody else, that would have been a good counter to a fireball. But
oh, he doesn't know how to punish that. And just got hit by the last hit.
Wow, there's an anti at level three. I have to say, there goes all her great health, but she's dead anyway. And a stylish finish from Raven. It's there.
Wow, and Effie just stood up and got up already. Now, tell me, what is your favorite game
right now?
What do you play right now?
I play Street Fighter 2. So
You play Street Fighter 2?
Yeah, HD Remix Classic.
Wow, okay.
It's the closest thing we're going to get to ST, you know.
On the PlayStation or on the arcade?
I'm not fussy, you know. I really am not fussy. Whatever's available, you know.
Yo, wait. Who's coming on stage?
Is it my
boy?
Whoa, is it Z?
It's Z.
It's Z and Haddishrooms. This might be interesting. Wait, does Z use Zangief?
This guy's not going to win Z. Z is too good.
Is Z a Zangief player?
Zangief.
Should we get a Zangief mirror?
This is desperation move. Matt Katz. Zeep.
I heard him complaining at DreamHack that they wouldn't give him the nice jersey with the proper one.
Really?
Yeah, he's complaining about it.
Okay. You know? I didn't hear that complaint.
I heard it.
But he's putting on the headset. He loves that sound coming out from Street Fighter Cross Tekken. One of the better soundtracks out there.
Yes, definitely.
Yes.
Again, this whole game is so under-nurtured, under-loved. I love this game, you know. I really embraced it. It was like Street Fighter 4, but it was like a fresh air. Fresh air. And I love the Tekken characters. I use a Tekken team. Mm-hmm. Kazuya, Haorong. You know, it's just... Wow, Logan doing some working out there.
I think Haorong has a lot of potential, but I haven't seen a lot of people using him at the moment. There's another character, I think is... Who's the guy with the seven different sets of moves from Tekken?
Oh, Lei.
Lei, yeah.
Nightmare.
Wow, that's crazy, man.
Nightmare. I used to use Lei back, so I used to play Tekken up to Tekken 2. When it got serious, I stopped. because it got hard. Wow. But Lei, with all those different starts, the crane, the dragon, you know, in again, alone in Tekken, it was quite tricky to deal with him. But in this game, where it's a more footsie based and it's more spacing,
I think. Sorry to cut you off there, but Momochi has came in front of us to sit down to watch Z play with intensity. Look
he
at
is,
that
look
size.
At the face,
the ninja eyes.
I think he could burn.
Yes, he's like
he could burn through the screen. With
he's
that.
He's either trying to stay awake from jet lag or really trying to watch the game and study what Z's got, because he's one of the guys to watch out for. Actually, Z just needs to make grand finals and he's in the 25th anniversary. And is gems allowed?
Gems are allowed. They are
really?
Allowed. Yes, without a doubt. We've always embraced gems in this country.
Why don't they use the set ID?
I think that's been disabled. I'm not sure, but no, there's a few guys that, you know, have got their gem sets, and
Z just turned off all his gems. Oh wait, I mean, Hadoom shrooms have been.
Oh, he doesn't use them.
Okay.
Thing is, though, you might just turn on. In my opinion, defense and power. Just turn them on. You know, to get the boost.
Yeah.
Why not? People play with.
Wait, Z's going to use gems, and Hadoom shrooms is not going to use gems. That's really weird.
Now, do you know what gems he uses?
He's going to use all defensive and
all
meter building. Yeah,
okay.
That's all you need. No, not many people use the damage ones because a lot of people just prefer the damage gem, the defense gems.
I know that I'm D'Artagnan. He's developed some nice tech with extend Pandora gem and then meter building gem.
Yeah.
So he'll do certain combos with, I think, a Buki Raven, and then he's just still alive, and the damage increases as well, and it's. You know, he's really put time and effort into. I know he's a community manager, but he really has put a lot of effort into developing some interesting tech. And he'll use Pandora every round on you.
I think Z's doing a great impression of infiltration right now. Studying his cell phone.
Yeah, take it out, you know.
Looking at the gems.
But I don't think he's got any knowledge on Hadoom shrooms. No,
I don't think so. But he knows. I'm surprised Did he pick... Oh wow, Dalsim Cody!
What's he doing?
Shout out.
Is that his team? Or is he just... styling.
This is his team.
Okay.
Cien told him to pick this team. I'm not sure if he's good at it. Hasn't been practicing. Wow.
This team's top tier, Ruffin man.
Kick.
Right, I doubt.
And he knows how to play against Zangief, so.
And I was saying earlier, though, you know, because a lot of us stop playing this game, you know, so DLC good. Characters are gonna.
Oh, nice. Pick up there.
Be difficult.
Oh, drops it. I don't think Z knows how to use Dalsim.
I think he's just. Taking the mickey, mate, as we might say, a little bit.
Ooh, see, he got it confused with the Street Fighter version. That's why he didn't get the sniper punch, the jump back.
Oh, yes. They reversed it again, the controls.
Yes.
I'm actually really tricky for Dalsim players. Every year, you know, every other game, they reverse the limbs.
Which is kind of irritating. And
sure.
You got to just rebuild the muscle memory.
I guess it must be really difficult. I guess there's no one that plays Dalsim in SF4 and then plays Dalsim in this. It must be too much of a headache.
I think Z is trolling here because he's terrible in Dalsim.
Would Z do that? Or he's... You know what? I love Z. He's a really nice guy, you know.
Yes.
He seems nice on camera and stuff, but in real life, he's a really genuine, you know, nice guy. You know?
Yeah, he is a really nice guy.
I like his jacket. I'm going to have to pinch it. Don't tell him.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, punish that. Come on, Z.
Oh, he's just throwing stones at Haddish Room. Take that. Oh.
What is he doing?
Wow, Ruffian kick.
I don't like his haha here. I prefer the Street Fighter 4 haha.
Is he in English or is he in Japanese vocals? That's what I don't know.
I think it's both the same.
Oh, is it?
In
okay.
English and Japanese. And he takes the first round, almost a timeout, with Cody on those nice stripes.
0-1!
Alright, let's see if Hadoom Shrooms can make adjustments.
Oh, wait a minute. We got... controller issues. Oh, it, Z of all people.
Yeah. Z with the grin.
I feel sorry for Z because.
Oh wait, his buttons were wrong.
I thought you were professional, Z.
He won that game with the wrong buttons. Shoutouts.
Thing is, Hadishrims, aka Michael Black, he's the wrong person to.
Oh my god.
He antagonizes you. I think the word troll. Oh. He's, you know, he's very vocal. So he's in your face. He's a really British lad, you know, all up in your face, you know. He's all fun, but sometimes it can be, I don't know, a bit intimidating. You know, he's a big chap as well, so And he's got that, he's got a northern accent. He's hard to understand. Even I don't understand him. Sorry, Michael. What? Please repeat. But I want to say, all you guys that are travelling to the UK, you know, welcome to the Great Britain, and I hope you've had a nice time, and I hope we've all been hospitable and welcomed
you. Oh, wow. Zsha have just teleported there to avoid the EX fireball, but he didn't do anything.
Oh, well, there's a button check. One second, you notice?
No, this is not a button check.
They're straight back in.
Yeah, this is straight
okay,
back
okay,
in.
I'm going to compensate then. Stop talking rubbish.
Oh, nice jump in. No anti-air from
oh, you know
rooms.
What? There's a nice air-to-air. Should have capitalized on that, but didn't.
The donkey kick.
Ooh, wow, nice reversal.
Ooh. Wow. I don't know why he did that right in front.
Risky switch.
All right. Ooh. Back. The combos are there now for Z. Much better. Much better gameplay now.
That's why Z was pushing. He thought Z was taking the mic.
Yeah.
What's he doing?
Ooh, wow.
Look at the range on the spinning bar drive. Puts Hanshi in a good position. Oh. Doesn't capitalize in the bounce.
Oh, nice tech there.
Great boost combo.
Ooh, drops the combo. I think that was supposed to be a super, but he drops it. Ooh, feels
oh,
to punish there.
What's going on?
I think Z takes this one.
Oh, look, Quaker's in the crowd. He's not impressed.
First game, 1-0. Well, he has to understand that Z's buttons are wrong. Which is kind of weird, because the previous guys were using the same sticks, right?
I'm not sure. Maybe no. I think no. The other player one was a pad player.
Okay.
So, but Z should know better than that. Always check your buttons.
Yes.
Shout out to button checks. You know what I hate? People do button check. They do the button check on the section stage. Do their gems. Go in the game. Do a button check and come out again. It's like, oh, yes. Guys, speed it up.
Ooh.
Ooh, nice boost coming to launch.
Okay. So, I don't understand this. How do Strooms choose not to use gems and Z is fully loaded with gems?
I think that is, again, I think a lot of us, again, we don't understand the gem sets, so we just kind of not use them.
Okay.
But as I said, just turn them on.
Yeah,
you know?
There's no harm. Just use all the defense gems and that's basically you're safe.
Or you know that if you're very offensive, maybe it's like, with me personally, because here, I just give him power. Because you know,
yep.
He's in your face. Duria, duria, duria. You know, I could do a little bit of a boost.
Yeah,
it's all fun.
But I think the damage scaling is so much that there's no real reason
right.
to use the,
well, of course.
The damage unless you're going for resets. But you know, in this game, you can do resets. It's not going to matter that much. That's why the defense gem is a much better choice. Oh, nice zoning. I think Hadou Stroom should definitely change out.
Yeah, listen, Michael. Don't be a hero. You know, nothing to prove.
Could be done now.
I think that might be it.
Ooh.
Oh, where's Yoga Flame?
You know, Z could have just teleported in front of Ryu. What is Z
what
doing?
What was that? Both of them, what are they doing?
Oh,
failed overhead.
Okay, time over. Z, in any case, if Hadou Strooms let go the EX or the Super, Z would have been hit by that.
Thing is, like, Cody's rushed down, so why is he not getting in there? I guess he's... Again, it's Zangief, isn't it?
Yeah.
Big target. You know.
All right, this is a good... He's going to keep Dalsim in because it's a good matchup against Zangief.
Yeah, definitely.
Ooh, nice. Oh, feels to punish there. I think Hadou Strooms is going for the SPD way too much. He should focus more on using the footsie game by Zangief, which is really, really strong in this version.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? Trying to anticipate a hit. Hit Dalsim's limbs, isn't it? And
yeah.
But it's not everyone can... I find it difficult to see. Me personally, I think Dalsim's a serious problem in this game. Kind of shuts down a lot of your offensive game.
Yep.
And then it...
Ooh, nice.
Wow, there you go. There's Yoga Fame finish. Backs up. Ooh, Yoga Tower. Cheeky, cheeky.
Well, a lot of people have problems with Dalsim because of the... damage output. It's actually very, very low. So you need to do a lot of hits and stuff.
Right.
Alright, Z takes this. I think this is the winner's finals for his group. So he made it. He has a huge smile on his face. It's like, that was great. That's what he looked like. And I think there's a
Momochi
confrontation.
Read,
oh, next up, Momochi.
Whoa. Walking around with that fighting edge joystick.
Momochi was saying to Z, good match, good stuff, man. I'm going to come and get you later.
Hey, you know what? This is going to be interesting because How to Read is one of our top UK Marvel players.
Yeah.
He's the guy with the, we call him the best beautiful Joe ever.
Wow, okay.
That's a big thing to say.
You better, better than Kusuro?
I'd like to see him a first to 10. See, nice. He's got a very strong, beautiful Joe. And he does play Cross Tekken. I think he uses Cammy. Last time I saw, this is like when the game first came out, it was Cammy and Nina. So he's no slouch. And this might be a pretty interesting match.
I'm actually really excited of this new IPL thing that's happening.
I saw that, but because it was, they announced it on Thursday, I think.
Yes.
I was sitting up here, I didn't get to read it, but I'm...
They're gonna have Capcom games except Marvel. All the other Capcom, I think it's Street Fighter.
Really?
Street Fighter Cross Tekken. It's gonna be really, really good. The price is gonna be insane. There's a lot of people that they brought in to hype up the event and to organize the event. I think they have a really good crew. I think it's gonna be a really exciting series of tournaments that's gonna happen. And right now, it's Eiji Momochi versus How to Read. Momochi with his favorite character, Cody and Rufus.
Oh no, this is going to be...
Both Rushdown.
Rushdown.
Versus Cammy and Nina, I think.
Yeah, Cammy and Nina. He hasn't changed.
How to Read?
I call him... How to...
How to Read... Going to be read like a book.
No, no. You watch. I'm not telling you nothing. Yeah.
Momochi almost got upset by what's that? Oh, who's this guy's name? I can't remember.
Hugo.
That's right.
Hugo's a skank though.
Yeah, but he almost got he lost one game to a Hugo player in Third Strike just now.
You know
what? The UK players. It was amazing.
Was it? Oh,
it was so hype.
Oh, you know what? There's a really good Hugo player, and he generally gives Ryan Hart a very hard time, for example. It might have been him.
I think it is him.
Yeah, it's him. I forget his name. I was helping out at a tournament in Wales, and oh my God, the guy walked in and he goes, where's Ryan Hart?
This is the first time ever that we've seen Momochi playing Street Fighter Cross Tekken on stream. This is the first time, and we're going to see a button check. Yeah!
Shout out to Button Check!
Now, Momochi... It's a ninja descent. He has lineage to real life ninjas in Japan.
Will you stop pulling my leg, please?
Oh no, I'm serious.
Oh my god!
He said it in an interview.
Really?
Look at him with that ninja stuff. Like, it's a ninja.
He's got this dark smoldering sort of aura around him.
Yes.
Like, respectful.
He didn't bring Choco Blanca this time because I think it was a short trip for him, and
that's a shame.
Yeah. Really like Choco Blanca. She's really nice. She's the cutest. She's one of the cutest girls I've ever met. She's so sweet, so cute, so talented.
She bodies you on video games. So you have to look at her differently afterwards.
Well, I've never played with her before. We usually just hang out and talk and stuff.
Cool.
Yeah. But yeah, she's really good too. Her Blanca is pretty legit.
You know who's really nice? She's one of the subject of cute girls, especially in FGC. Kyane. You know, just...
Kyane, where is she? She's in France.
You know, if there was Soul Calibur here, should be here.
She plays Street Fighter.
She does. You know, but, you know, she's become over to a few of our tournaments over here.
Yep.
Lovely girl, you know, really sweet. And she gets swarmed a lot. The guys get a bit excited.
It's Kyane.
Yeah, like, come on, guys. It's just a girl. There's loads of them in the world, you know. But, no, lovely. Shout out to Kyane. Come back soon.
Just like Momochi watching Z play just now, Cody. Now Z is watching Momochi play and see, maybe he can pick up a few moves. Ooh, nice anti-air there.
Swapping
into a combo. Much frame traps.
Frame traps, as I say. Cody's frame traps, they're so authentic from Street Fighter. Ooh, good combo. He got big damage from Rufus.
Okay, these two characters are what Z plays as well. Z also uses Rufus and Cody. Ooh, nice.
Again, Hatchery's got a really nice cabby in this game. Utilizes the jump cancels a lot. And a very strong Nina. There's not very many Ninas left. I think a lot of people switched. Lily for Nina, and stuff. But, you know, Hatchery's been faithful to Nina since point one. So let's see what he's got, basically.
Yep. But it doesn't look like Momochi's doing much. He's just down. It's just a down light kick into standing middle kick.
One of the best. Cody's best. Oh, there's that. Wow. So that back medium punch. Nice counter hit.
Nice grab there. Ooh, I don't know why he tags out.
Worth the risk, you know, it paid off.
I don't think he paid off.
Well,
he should have just continued with a mix-up into a rushdown and then try to tag out because the time is almost up, so there's no reason for him to
switch. I guess you're right there.
Yeah. So now he's not able to do anything. And if he kept on the pressure instead of tagging out and giving the advantage back to Momochi, he could have just rushed down more.
Yes.
So don't look at your life, look at the game.
See, that's what I do. I spend too much time looking at life sometimes, you know.
Yeah.
That's my problem, you know. So I do play the game, I do enjoy it, but I don't look at the intricacies sometimes of it. And but say, Cross Tekken, it's a great game, you know, so, and people should play more. So I'm hoping.
Oh, nice dive. See, this is what I hope. Ono just announced that he might do a 2013 update, and that's what I hope he nerfs. Cammy's dive kick because it's so strong, and in this version the dive kick is not as strong as the one in Street Fighter 4. Wow!
Has he been getting anything off this?
Cross assault.
Sometimes it does pay off, doesn't it? Other times.
Oh, all right.
Okay, back in the corner. Finish with the Yep, definitely.
Messiah kick.
I say.
Wow! More combos.
Wow! Say Cody, probably one of the strongest.
Wow! Nice
DLC
cross
characters.
Up there. That's the end of the game.
That's it.
I think Cody's strongest suit will be his overhead.
Yep. Oh yeah. Definitely.
It's so dangerous, and you can tag in and tag out people. It's plus on block.
And again, it's a hard forward hard punch overhead. It's got good damage, better damage than most, isn't it? So,
I think Howard Reed is a good player. I mean, he's holding up pretty well against Momochi, but I think it's just Momochi is just too strong right now.
And again, so I think it's a lack of Cody knowledge in this game as well, and. Rufus is, but you're right, definitely. Rufus is always a
customer. I don't think How to Read has a bad, does not know the matchup. I think he's just out footsie by Momochi. Momochi's footsie is so good that he's not able to do anything. Yeah. Oh, nice launcher. Nice rush down there by Momochi. Continues to combo.
Oh, did they finish it correctly?
Ooh,
maybe.
And that's it. A nice round there. Now he's on match point. Let's see what How to Read can do. I really don't think How to Read is able to crack Momochi's defense.
No,
I think his reactions, his spacing, his footsies, look
yeah,
at that.
Yeah, exactly what you're saying.
Yeah, he's just too strong. It's just the basics that, you know, it's not even, you know, a rushdown or anything, but Momochi's basics are so strong that it's really hard for How to Read to just get in on Momochi. And almost a perfect there. Momochi takes the game. And this shows, I mean, this one of the most important things to learn in fighting game basics is just the basics of footsie, spacing, and everything.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, like, a lot of people. I had this conversation with people that when Marvel came out, guys never played it in the world. And on the eve of Marvel 3 coming out, Marvel 2 got a bit more exciting. People go, I'm learning the Iron Man Infinite. Mm-hmm. Like, what for? Why don't you learn? I'm not being funny. Go, why don't you just learn the basics first? And like, I mean, some guys forget to learn the basics sometimes. Good fundamentals.
Yep.
It's definitely the way forward. Understanding your normals.
I think people like to learn the fun stuff first, like the infinites and stuff, and then maybe later on move into the normals and the footsies and stuff. Maybe that's what you need to do. Just let people get used to it first and like the game for what the game is. Like, if they like to do infinites, let them learn how to do infinites first. And then after that, when they are really, you know, really into the game, into the tournament scene, then you start learning about footsies, learning about spacing, about counters, frame traps, and stuff. And I think that's a good engagement too. That's how I think. Like, and I understand where you're coming from. Like, you need to teach people.
You do, yes, of course. If you want to, end of the day, learn the game how you want to learn it.
Yes.
And the stuff. But my thing is that sometimes the guys, they want to. It's like they want to learn to run before they can even crawl. Sometimes, and I guess you can parrot style certain people and get away with it, you know, and, you know, ditto, everyone, you know, we all learn fighting games in a slightly different manner, and, yeah. you know, and...
And in some players are just not good at footsie, so they...
They need that.
Yeah, they might need to do some other stuff that, you know, make them better in the game. Now, Z is doing a button check and picking out his gems again, making sure... Let's see if he learned anything from Momochi. He really admires Momochi. Him and Cien both think Momochi is a fantastic player. Admire him a lot in his Street Fighter Third Strike gameplay. It's... You know, he's really a very amazing player. I don't know if a lot of people have a chance to watch him play, but, you know, using a character like Cody,
yep.
it's really, really difficult. And he switched from Ken and Akuma to Cody in Street Fighter 4.
Okay.
Yeah, and I think he's one of the hot favorites to win this tournament, but I think Reinhardt is going to give him a run for the money because, you know, Reinhardt can easily just pick up Yuen and try to rush Cody down. In the main tournament.
We need to, you know, Ryan's definitely one of Ryan's main games here. He is, was, you know.
Oh, wait. What's this? No, synchronized phone checking.
No, I think he's just sending a tweet, Afi, you know, just, yeah, I'm on stage, everyone. Check it out. You know, but.
Z spotting the Samsung Galaxy S3.
Wicked phone? Wicked phone. I like the mini, actually. That's even.
Wow, okay.
Even sweeter, but.
He wants to get the Note 2. That's what he wants to get. So if he wins today, he's going to go buy the Note 2.
Good on him. You know, I love the Galaxy range. You know,
what phone do you have?
I have an S2.
Oh, wow. Okay. So, me too.
Can't go wrong with...
I like the S2 better than the S3.
I prefer the S2. People are, oh, I've got to get an S3. It's like, really?
I don't like the design of the S3.
No, I don't. No. To me, it's all like, it's like a polished rock.
Yeah.
You know, it's nice. Maybe it's more geared to girls with the curved edges in there. I don't know, but you know, this is definitely, you know, endorsing Samsung products on the Street Fighter Cross Tekken event.
All right, right now is Desperation Move, Mad Cat Z versus WSO
Afi.
Cody and Rufus, right after watching Momochi play, he soaked up the knowledge and changed to Cody and Rufus. Momochi is looking at Z like, what? Did you just plagiarize me?
Afi's got good facing. Sorry, good spacing. Good footsie. Wow. Let's see how this battle pans out.
Well, I've seen Afi play. I think Z should be able to win this.
Of course, good stuff from Afi. Sorry,
I just cursed the... Yeah, maybe, I'm going to back...
Oh, there's that overhead. It's a loop. He needs to get a loop down, though. You know, two straight hits. Wow.
Just straight. Wow. Launcher.
Put out those low moves.
Oh, wow.
This is it.
All right. Z has to concentrate more. I think he got callous.
Maybe.
Got a mental break there.
What I said earlier, Afi really strong. Very comfortable with the game. Wow, look nice. At that. Utilizing. Oh, he needs to really get those loops down, though.
Ooh.
Wow, I think.
A failed combo there.
Getting a bit worried.
Yes.
Pushing buttons. Is. Good teleport. Oh, no, bad teleport, even. Oh, look at the cross up on the dive kick.
Nice block there by Afi. Ooh, nice.
Wow, and denied.
Oh, nice grab there. One more mix up. Ooh, nice, he got it.
Anticipated the roll.
Yes. And you know, Rufus has really good range on this down fierce.
Down fierce, yeah.
Into launcher.
I mean, that's a bit ridiculous how far he can get it from, but it's in the game, you know. It's those long range
yep.
Pokes into launch, like Guy as well.
Yep.
Yeah, standing medium, you know, hard.
Ooh. A missed combo there. Launcher from Z.
Oh,
doesn't connect.
Nice S air.
Ooh. Caught Z pressing buttons. Z has level 3 right now. Let's see what he can do.
Oh, didn't finish off.
I think he wanted Cody to get more life before he tags him in. One more mix up. Ooh, misses the grab.
Is that jab pressure?
Punish. Nice punish there by Z.
Okay, rolls out the corner.
Fails to punish the roll.
Shame. Good air to air, but didn't capitalize.
Oh, that was terrible teleport there by Effie.
It's big damage. Oh, drops it.
Nice launcher from Z. I think he's able to close it out. He plays it safe. Oh, he shouldn't have chased him down. Wise choice from Z. Training out Rufus. Taking in Rufus. And I think he takes this round.
Yeah, Zay,
and this game.
Z definitely controlled the pace on that round, you know.
Yeah. I think Z's got a hang of it, but I think his Cody needs a lot of work. He hasn't been using Cody a lot, and I think he just started picking it up. And you can really tell the difference between Z's Cody versus Momochi's Cody. And Momochi's Cody is definitely way better than Z's Cody right now. Effie is just zoning out right now, and Z is trying to build some meter.
Wow, but he's falling for it, though.
Yeah, he's losing the fireball battle, that's for sure.
Landing on those Sonic Booms.
Ooh, failed to end the air. Big punish here.
Yeah, keeping it simple. So I can go out back in.
A good punish there, but he's standing fierce.
Oh, I thought Z was going for the throw there.
Yeah, I think Z needs to tag out. A good choice there. To be honest, I think Z is really trolling. He doesn't even use... This is the first time I've seen him use Cody. And I don't know why he's using Cody. Because he's not really good at it.
Maybe he shouldn't underestimate some of our players. Oh, good backdash. Well,
because his Marduk is really, really good. And so is his Geef.
Marduk is underused, difficult carrots, you know, great damage output, great combo.
Ooh, kills to punish.
And that cross up as well, you can't really see.
Ooh!
Oh,
that was a great chance for Z to come back, but with time running out, he really needs to make something happen. And from the front!
Ooh, not sure what he can do here, not much.
Ooh! Is Z able to.
Oh, he's fighting.
Oh, I don't think Z is able to make it. Just way too much damage.
Wow, that medium kick at the air.
Yeah. He dropped way too much combos. He almost had a comeback coming, but just wasn't able to connect all his combos. Oh, now you don't see Effie just trying to zone him out, but just straight up attacking Z right now. Which I don't think is working out for him. I think he should have just played the fireball game, which he was very strong at. And he just let Z get in on him.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Out of the corner, we're back in the corner again now.
Ooh, fails to punish the flash kick. Okay, I think Effie now got the picture.
Yeah, he's going back to what you were doing. Oh, there's
that. Level 3!
He really does capitalize in level 3. Does.
It's alright because Z has a level 3 of his own and you need to do the cross assault.
Yeah, as you said.
Yep.
Just even out the energy.
Yep. Oh, wow. Nice overhead there.
Sometimes it does work out, doesn't it?
No, both almost at even. Ooh, nice punish. I think Z, if he doesn't drop... there you go, he drops his combo.
Maybe we should go for something a bit easier.
Ooh,
maybe
nice.
Just medium punch into...
Yes.
Kamalapa, maybe.
Ooh, nice.
Ooh, nice launcher.
Launcher there.
Oh, free medium punch to flash kick. Oh, good pressure in the corner.
Ooh.
Oh, come on.
Oh, he dropped the combo. That was so big.
Wow, empty jump into big combo. Oh, yeah, again, keep it simple.
Z's going to be angry with himself. He had the game in on lockdown, and he just messed it up.
Oh, and there's that good fight. That was a nice fight. I like that round.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
1-1. I think Z should kick himself. He missed a lot of big combos there.
Oh, look, you can see it in his face as well.
Yeah, he's like... I'm really salty right now. And I think he's going to the character select screen. Please bring out Marduk. Please, see. Don't be fraudulent.
Yeah, well, you know what? Have you two got some sort of telepathic link going on? Or you just know each other really well?
I've seen these guys play way too much. I know what Cien is going to do. I know what Z is going to do. You know, when you edit videos and you do a lot of fighting game commentary and you watch a lot,
yeah.
You know, you just get a feeling of what these characters can do and stuff. Now, Z is going to go into his... gem selection again. and picking all the defense jams. And this is good. This is good for Momochi because he was too lazy, I guess, to pick the gems. But now Z has picked the gems for him. So he's, you know, Momochi right now is smiling like, yeah, I don't have to pick gems anymore.
Like, and his phone's out,
yep.
Inputting the data.
No, I don't think he needs to because most of the games he's going to play is on stream from now on. So he's like, all right, so Z's done all the gems and homework for me. I don't have to do anything. He's deleting the gem data.
Thumbs up, partner.
All right.
I do enjoy watching Marduk.
Yeah, Z's Marduk is sick. And he just drops a combo. Wow.
Good air grab.
That was a really nice air grab. Oh, nice combo there. Drops the combo from Rufus.
Last right from Afi. Oh, rolls out of the corner.
Ooh, nice
good
anti-air.
That's good anti-air. It was one of the best in the game.
The stop sign. Another air grab. Ooh, nice.
I think Afi this time definitely just going to try and control space rather than going for combo to Kyle.
I don't think Afi knows the Marduk matchup too well.
I don't think he does, to be honest with
you. He has a lot of ambiguous cross-ups.
A lot of stone. I think only one player I knew that when the game was popular, I played with Marduk in London anyway. It was SYN Aaron.
Yep.
And he was a king. Marduk is very difficult, trust me. Oh, anticipates that roll.
Oh, nice.
Lovely combo. Got a loop on. Ah.
Wow.
Look at that. Stylish overhead. For the win.
Right now, Effie is on match point. Z better bring it, or is he going to be in deep trouble? Look at.
Wow.
Ooh.
Oh, look at that EX grab.
That was on the ground. Oh, fails to put on the pressure. Ooh, nice. Z has to keep on punishing him and getting the combo straight. He's been dropping way too many combos, and I think that has really cost him a lot of the matches.
Ooh, nice. EX Messiah. Nice switch. There's that grab. Ugh. In your face.
Ooh,
wow,
nice.
Nice anticipated. Now what can we do in the corner? Ah, drops the end of it.
Ooh! Oh,
not a good
tag. A terrible
tag
in from
not a good tag. I used to think that was a safe option.
Wow! Nice air grab for the Messiah.
Ooh, good anti-air. Ooh, teched.
I think Z has a bad habit. Every time he anti-airs, he jumps forward.
That's what I was gonna say.
Yeah. And Effie did not catch that.
But I do that sort of thing as well. Anti-air, a close-up anti-air like that. You think, yeah, I can probably cross up or...
Yeah.
I'm guilty of that as well.
All right, final round, final game. Z, please do it for us. We need that pound, that British pound.
That's it. Match point, Z. Match point, Afi.
We need the car. Do it for us. Ooh, nice.
That grab.
Nice grab.
Oh, he dashes up.
Nice roll.
Ooh. Wow, armor on the backhand.
Yes!
Oh no, be careful.
Good punish there by Z.
And there comes Rufus.
Oh, another launcher.
He wants Murdoch back in the action.
A good block, but...
Nah, Z's...
Okay, one more mix-up. Yes!
Wow! No!
No!
Z! What is he doing? What is going on?
No, he got a cross assault. Oh, nice blocking there by Z.
Oh, Z should go for the combo. What's going on? Is that standing jab pressure?
Oh, nice OTG there. Okay, Z is in trouble right now.
Wow. Oh, Afi, come on. Oh. Tournament nerves.
That was definitely tournament nerves from Z.
Nice. He should have converted off that jump hard kick.
Yep. Now the pressure. Z just needs to put on pressure. Oh, that was a terrible tag in.
That was not a good decision. Wow.
Wow, nice combos.
And that's it.
Z takes it. Z takes the round. Moves on to winner's finals. Or is it just... You know, winners finals of his pool.
Definitely.
And into the top, I think top 8. That was a very exciting match by Z.
Z just put his foot on the gas then, didn't he?
Yes, he did. Effie is now talking to Z about what happened during the matchup. That was a really exciting match. Down to the wire. Effie really gave Z a lot of problems. I think Z should have just stopped with Marduk from the start.
That was really enjoyable. You know, Marduk in your face, just grappler. Yeah. I love it.
Such a man's man.
That's it. Why are you looking at me? whatever he says. I can't remember. You're really annoying me or something, isn't he? Like,
I'm just shocked that Z even started trolling with Cody. It's just ridiculous. He should be ashamed of himself. But I think he really thinks Cody is a good character, and he thinks that Momochi might... He's thinking in the long run, because I think right after this he plays Momochi.
Yeah.
Because these two groups are playing at the same time. And I think if he faces Momochi, he needs some character understanding of what Cody can do. And I think Madouk is a good matchup for Cody.
Cody, yeah?
Yeah. And I think he has a good chance to take Momochi, or put up a good fight with Momochi, because I think Momochi might lack the matchup knowledge for Madouk.
The thing is, for me, it's difficult for me to like even give opinions, especially like any of the DLC characters. I said we don't see a lot of it. A lot of us don't say the scene vanished. I've got DLC characters. Like, guys, let's have a session. Cross Tekken, like, yeah. So like, you know, in other countries, other regions, I guess they kept on playing, and the text there. I think it's difficult for me to, you know, respond to you with by the text that Cody might have, because I don't know it.
Yep.
At all. It's like...
Well, I've been watching a lot of streams. Not because I've been playing a lot, but I've been watching a lot of streams. I've been catching up with fight videos. And I've seen, you know, Cien and Z play Cody a lot. So I get a lot of advantage. And they... And, you know, I was in the Taiwan finals and they played a variety of characters.
Right, okay.
So I have that advantage over, you know... Where you probably haven't had a chance
well,
to go
tell,
watch.
Well, tell a lie. I do watch Event Hubs rather closely, and I did notice there are lots of streams. No, looks like these at the moment. A lot of those hour segments, high level Street Fighter second videos are back, but they disappeared for a while, didn't they? So I've been watching it recently, but especially with this event coming up.
Yep. I want to give the shout outs to SRK and especially Event Hubs as well. John from Event Hubs, S. Philip. All these guys have really done a great job to help the community move along and globalize the community.
Yep.
Because everyone around the world has got visits SRK, iPlayWinner, and Event Hubs. All three of them. All these three websites are really a really good like resource.
Resources, yeah. You know, for me, when I want to go on my FGC, you know, adventure on the internet, straight away, I say Event Hubs first, Shuriken second. I sometimes forget about iPlayWinner because sometimes I do, and he didn't hear me. Because
I love iPlayWinner. I don't know about you. I check it all the time because
I'm a King of Fighters guy, and I did for a while, but those sites are great. You know, they really have kept, you know, clear. Globally, the scene vibrant.
Now I'm very sure Momochi is just going to rush down all the way because he doesn't want any shenanigans from Alicia, because I'm pretty sure he doesn't have any matchup knowledge. But he did block the cross-up kick just now, which means I think he's been watching Alisa play just now.
Oh.
Ooh, nice. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Is
two for one.
Birthday?
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Still in there.
It's so hard to see. They look like they're one and the same.
Yeah, like almost same body shape.
Yeah. That's insane. That's crazy, right?
You see what?
Except the little skirt from Alisa.
It was difficult to see.
Yes. Ooh, oh, nice.
Nice poke.
See, this is what good basics will bring you.
Mm.
Once you have the good basics, no matter what the matchup is, you still know how to play it.
I have noticed that with Cody, down short, standing forwards, it's quite safe in certain distances, and you can abuse it, you know, until it connects and converts to a combo.
I don't think you see Momochi rolling at all. It's just straight.
Nah,
get
he
up.
Knows, yeah. No point sometimes. Oh, counter hit charged.
I think Arisno also knows that Momochi is not familiar with this matchup because he's been getting away with love a few stuff, you know what I mean? Wow.
Wow,
there was the counter right there.
Finally seeing alpha counter, but didn't really work out.
Nice combos. As you can see, Momochi has all the gems fully loaded.
That's what I had to say.
And Arisno has no gems. Is this a gentleman's game today?
I do believe so.
I think you British guys really need to just put in the gems. It's a huge disadvantage. Like right now, the damage could have been reduced greatly. Look, Momochi has full meter. Oh wait.
No, come on.
They do have the gems. Alisa does have gems in, but Julia does not have gems. That's kind of strange.
That's interesting.
And Momochi didn't put gems for Rufus.
Or maybe gems, they were rubbish gems, I suppose, in their opinion. God knows.
All right, Momochi takes the first game. Wait, I think they used up the gems. Let's check when you hit the rematch. Yeah, Momochi has fully loaded gems while... Oh, both have fully loaded gems. All right. I was confused. Sorry, that's my fault.
Oh, look, everyone.
Let's heat things up.
Earned a trophy. Wow, it was a high-low.
I wonder where did Alisa keep those blades?
I'm sure they're not out all the time. She can
activate
them.
Yep. Oh, nice rushdown there by Momochi. Combo time, launcher. Nope.
Oh, that's good finisher.
Wow. Just rush into it.
Let's see where he gets off this.
Great juggle there.
Oh, does it fail to finish it off? Nice boost combo.
Oh, that's a terrible tag in.
Not always a good decision.
Wow.
Wow, did not see where Rufus was going.
Yep. I wonder, that's the second time that Arisano did that. And
the overhead technology.
Done.
Wow. Very, very strong performance from Momochi.
Momochi. I'm sure Chocobanka is watching anxiously on stream, cheering Momochi on. Shout outs to Chocobanka. Haha.
Wow, that's a long range poke.
No, both players are just keeping a distance. Nice block there by Momochi. Ooh, nice anti-air. Now, 55 seconds is gone.
See, look, the blades are gone. I don't think...
Ooh, nice. Nice pickup there from Momochi.
Here comes that usual... corner stuff
this
from
is match point for nice cross up.
Is that cross up? Well,
yeah,
obviously it is.
Cross up.
Wow,
it's the same as the Street Fighter 4 cross up. All right, one more mix up. Ooh, just switch out, man. Just switch out. Oh, good choice there. Let's hope the computer is good at Alisa.
Good low sweep.
Oh, nice. So much pressure from Momochi. Just down. Don't like kicking to standing forward,
and as soon as it connects, straight into launcher.
Yeah.
What mix up he's going for this time?
From the front.
Can I also get Chai Rithi and Shell, please? Chai Rithi and Shell.
Well, definitely adapting on the fly, learning Alisa as he goes
and
along.
And Momochi takes it 2-0. Arisano goes down to the loser bracket. Momochi moves on. I think Momochi will face Z later on in the evening, but right now, Momochi and Z are in to the top 16 or top 8? I'm not sure. I think it's top 8.
That's kind of cool for you, isn't it? I'd like to know how the rest of the bracket is going on, because they are strong players. See how far they're getting. But
I really hope Z wins this.
You're really going for Z, aren't you?
Yes, because then he has a chance to win the car. And he wants, you know, if Z wins the car in Street Fighter Finals in San Francisco, he's going to give it to Sien. Because he wants to own a car.
That's really cool.
So,
That's really cool.
Yeah, that's really cool.
That generosity. But I think so. I've spoken for like half an hour.
Z's playing right there. So is he playing casuals or he's? I think he's just practicing. Yeah, he has to be practicing. Because I don't think we've seen Z play quite a few matches already, and he's playing against people that have moved on pretty far in the game.
It's a shame. I would like to have seen I'm Still the Daddy up on stream.
Yep.
It's got excellent guile and lore combination.
So guys, hold on. Please support the UK FGC by following this guy right here.
Media. We're trying to raise the level, of the presentation of events in the UK, and
And they need your stream numbers. Please, always watch the streams.
When they're on. You know, we don't get to...
Well, when they're off, nobody's going to watch anyway.
Of course not. You know, we don't get to stream as much as we'd like to, but yep. Who does anymore? Who does?
Everybody streams. And follow SG Esports.
You see that? How am I going to do it? Whoa.
Oh. Woo, woo.
Yep.
All right, great. And follow Zeep at Z-H-I-E-E-E-P or Haunts at H-A-U-N-T-S.
And to keep... You know.
So I got my dream. It's Momochi versus Z.
Also,
and Z looks a little defeated. I don't think that's the kind of energy that he needs going into this match. Be positive, Z.
Wow,
come on. You can do it.
Don't shake your head.
Let's do this. Do it for Choco. Break. You know why he's disappointed? Because he knows that if he wins Z, he's going to break Choco Blanca's heart. And you know, Choco Blanca is so sweet and so nice. And so cute.
And so this is...
And Z can't crush...
This battle is more than just sprites on a screen. This is...
It's
real.
It's real.
It's real here. So,
and he feels terrible that, you know, he has to... If he beats Momochi, Choco will be very sad. And, you know, Z is a true gentleman.
Oh, come on. There's two options here. Win or lose. Yeah? You decide. That's up to you.
He's a very nice guy. And he's a ladies' man. So if he wins Momochi, Choco Blanca at home will be very sad. And, you know, Z is not there to console her. Momochi is not there to console her. No one's there. She's alone hugging the teddy bear.
Anyway, I shouldn't have said that.
Starting out the drama.
Many apologies. There's enough drama in FGC. Don't create any more.
So much drama in FGC.
Everywhere. Oh, my gosh. It's definitely an exciting place.
All right. So, I don't know what Z is doing, but he's probably configuring his gems.
Nice button check.
Button checks.
In-game.
In-game button checks.
Save a bit of time, I suppose.
This is a great matchup. Momochi is having a smile in his face. I don't see him have a slight grin. Z is excited. He says... He whispers something to Momochi. He's like, oh, how am I going
to
do this?
Have to?
I don't really want to beat you because... You know, I don't want Choco to cry. She's alone in... I think she's still in the Kansai area. He's trying to move down to Tokyo, but he's still up north, I think. And that's where a lot of good players are. Udyo, Haitani. Those players are all from Kansai area. While I think it's Kansai. I might have pronounced it wrong. But so there's always... there's two really strong regions for Japan. One is in Tokyo, where... Tokido, Mago, Daigo are,
sure.
And Fudo, and Bonchan, all these players. And then there's the North players where, you know, there's Kindevu, Momochi, Haitani, Uryo.
You see, that sounds a lot like what we've got in this country. We've got London in the South.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to use Marvel as an example. We've got the Syndicate, three guys, very, very strong. We've got How to Read. We've got One Up Miles. Mm-hmm. There's so many more. So many Marvel players out there. So many strong Marvel players. Sexy Mills, Bebop.
Wait. Z is using Marduk now. See, he was trolling at the start. Now he's straight up Marduk.
That's it. Down to business.
Either that, or he doesn't want to show Momochi his Marduk. And it was a high-level Yomi mind games. You know, Reinhardt is very famous for his mind games.
Yep.
So Z has taken some part from MCC, WW, Reinhardt, and pick Cody on purpose, and then switch to Marduk when he faces Momochi.
Right, so just psyching him out there.
That's right. And, you know, Momochi is not picking Rolento and Ryu, so, you know, there's not really a lot of rush down there. And, you know, Z really has a problem with Rolento, and Momochi without Rolento is pretty good. It's a good game matchup for him, because he knows this matchup. Oh, nice anti-air there by Momochi.
Well, I know very little about either of these guys, so I'm just going to, you know, let you know, do most of the talking.
No, I'm sure you can watch and understand the flow of the
definitely.
Game.
But if you know, like, game plans and stuff, you probably know better these things than I do.
Nice launcher there. Well, Momochi has been playing the same playstyle all along, which is the right playstyle. And it's just footsies all the way and frame traps and just try to get as much damage as possible.
As he's doing right now. Yes. It's not looking good for Z.
Oh, nice!
Gets
Nice backhand there.
Out of there. And nice. Let's see what sort of pressure. Oh, nice alpha counter.
Oh, nice block there by Z. Z's doing really well handling the pressure from Momochi, but right now he's in a world hurt. He's still in this though.
Wow, good cross up. Great conversion. Wall bounce. Oh, launch and finish. Wow, look at that. Wow. Crossed up.
I think Z is a little overwhelmed right now. He needs to confidence. Oh, that's
a very, very convincing performance there from Momochi.
He needs to, Z needs to pull himself together right now. He needs to rethink his strategy, calm down, and try to regain his composure in this game.
Ooh, wow. Careful. Don't put too many buttons, Z.
Yeah, nice punish there by Momochi.
Good roll. Ooh, to get nice. Out of danger. There comes that command grab. I love that grab. It's so nasty. Imagine that happened to you in real life.
Just one hand slam you to the ground.
Here comes
nice overhead there. So
what's he
going to
do here? Pretty Oh, really?
Yeah. Not enough
to
kill.
Wow, did he kill him?
Across assault there. Wise choice. Ooh. Wow, happy birthday
there.
Goes
both of them.
Oh, that's not good.
And
this is bad
there.
News. Wow, this is really bad news for Z.
It's still going. Wow. Again, using the forward high kick to cross up.
All right, Z, not sure what to do. A little overwhelmed. Momochi's like, I got this. I'm going to kill you, crush you. Then I'm going to go back and hug Choco Bunga.
You know what? He's got that fighting edge stick. We don't get those over here. At all. It's the first time I've seen it in the flesh.
Okay.
I thought I'd say that. If I probably shouldn't. But you know.
Okay. I think Z's going to change some game plan. What is he going to switch to? Dalsim.
Okay.
I think this might be a bad... Dalsim and...
Oh, I like this.
Marduk. You like this?
I like this. You know what? It's not a conventional team you'd see. Well, not that I've
definitely
seen.
Definitely not conventional.
So, you know, it's going to be very, very predictable sometimes, especially at high level. So, you know, sometimes the element of surprise could work, you know?
Well, Dalsim is... He used Dalsim as a launcher and then Marduk as the damaging
getting
character.
Close.
Get the damage.
Again, a very... Keep, you know, Dalsim, keep him out. And then Marduk gets him. And obviously that you can do the jump in. Was it Yoga Sniper?
Yes, Yoga Sniper.
Sniper into to tag to you know, safe. One of the safest ways of tagging.
Yep. Okay, let's see if there's a change of game plan here. Sorry, I'm watching an Atlas. Oh, that's a terrible start for Z right now. Atlas, can you play? Ended up in the corner. Ooh, nice cross up
cross
there.
Up.
Ooh, drops the combo.
Doesn't matter though. Keeping him in the corner, that's not a good place to douse him at all.
Yes.
See if he can switch out.
Oh, wow.
Spoke too soon. Let's see if it's any way he can switch out. Even a raw switch, you know.
Yeah.
It's probably worth a try, but not the best start for Z, but...
Well, I think... Ooh, nice there.
Great combo. Shame. Drops the grab.
No. He drops the grab again.
Oh, good punishment for doing so.
Oh, a very unlucky break there for Z. Ooh, nice.
Lovely.
Get him. Wow.
Ooh, good
Messiah
kick. Wow, look at the combo. Styling and profiling. Yes, baby. I like that. Look at that.
Ooh, another nice cross up there.
Doesn't block the dive kick.
And I think if Z doesn't do anything right now, it's done for him. Cross assault. Oh, no! What are you doing?
Why not?
For?
If you're going to go out, go out
giving
in style.
Up. Come on, Z! What are you doing?
Oh, but
no!
I think he deserves a prize just for using Pandora.
Momochi gives a smile.
And look at that.
Clap from the crowd.
Smiles. You know what I mean? These guys, good friends.
Oh, Choco is happy at home. Momochi is happy. Z is happy. Everyone leaves happy.
I'm happy. Are you happy?
No, Z lost. Beer skin here?
Right, we're back on this.
A shop.
We can't see.
Update. Wait.
Right.
This is called beer skin hat.
Which I didn't know.
Is it beer skin or bear skin?
Bear skin.
Bear skin. Yeah, that makes sense. So Bearskin. Does every constable?
Okay, sorry. No, it's the court of the guard, I think. And
the court of guard.
They are.
Do they need to fight a bear like Zangief to?
No, I think they
officially wear this
I
hat.
I think they might send Zangief, pay him, you know, give him a little bit of money. Let Zangief go fight the bear, but
fight Kuma.
Love those guys. You can just do anything you like in front of them, and they'll just stand to attention.
Wow, all right.
Yeah, like, come on, are you?
I think all military have to do that.
But these guys, they just get it because the hat is rather comical. So we've all done it, you know. We've all done it. We were little school trips, and you got you're 8 years old. You just want to punch
shout
him.
Shout outs to the real life trolls. we thought the FGC was trolling.
Oh yeah, it starts from a young age, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Remember before the internet
the
was.
British people trolling with the
it's the good old British sense of
bearskin hat.
Have you had a cup of tea since you've been here?
I've been to England about 5 times, so I have many cups of tea.
Oh, actually, you've been here. So yes. I know it's Combo Fiend's first trip. And he was so hype about having a cup of tea. So I'm going to go and buy him a box of PG Tips. Yes. Yeah, and wrap it up for him and give it to him. I have
to. It's like, I drink Lipton, so.
Okay.
I drink the generic stuff. But it's like, you know, in Star Trek, they go, Earl Grey hot.
Yes, you know what? I had to say,
it's like Bond.
Get him some Earl Grey and some Twinings.
Twinings?
So I'm going to say it all proper now. Twinings. Oh. Yeah, okay. My mom drinks that. It's all like. Right. Honey and herb lemon and all these medicinal and keep you calm and, you know, composed. Yep. My mom drinks them. Like, Richard, give me some tea. It's like PG Tips, mom. No, I want some Earl Grey or Twinings. My mom's a rather posh lady.
I like tea with toast, and then I just dip the toast in the tea and put lots of sugar.
You're down with us, man. Tea and toast.
Yes.
You had tea and Twix.
I already told you, Singapore is a colony.
I know.
Of the British Empire.
How about tea and Twix?
Tea and Twix.
That's a very British thing.
Yeah, we don't.
That's
do
you need
tea
to try that before you go. Tea and when you get home, tea and Twix.
I will try that.
The ultimate break.
All right.
Yeah, endorsements of Twix. I watch too much telly.
I love drinking tea. I don't think I do that enough anymore in Singapore. They kind of have a lot of like little pockets of tea shops where everybody just drinks tea for lunch and stuff. And it's a really throwback to the British style of way of life where people still stop for lunch and then after tea
You have the tea, you know, afternoon tea, which not everyone get. Even we don't get it sometimes. You've got to drink it with a pinky, like.
You know,
keep it, you know, keep it, keeping it British, keeping it classy, you know.
The pinky up.
That's it.
Pinky.
And what else do I want to... Yeah, we've exposed Combo Fiend to some of our devilish English ways, haven't we?
But I know tradition.
Yeah, you know, he's had the wicked time, you know. He's been great to have. He's so different to what I thought he would be as well. Like, shout out to Combo Fiend. When you're watching this back, you know...
He's playing Marvel right now.
Yeah, he is,
in the Marvel
he?
Tournament. Yes, he says that he wants to win those British pounds.
He went down to Wednesday's on... No.
Yeah, he won everything.
He won that, and then he went to back to Gamer Base the night afterwards, and he was pretty good again. And everyone's out to get him. It's funny.
Yeah,
it happens. Like when Daigo came over here, everyone's out to get him.
Who?
Daigo. Back in 2010, all out to get him, and then who else came over? And out to get him.
Did anybody?
Justin Wong.
Reinhardt beat him, right?
Yeah. No, that was Superverse Battle Tournament, and
okay,
it was. No. Right, sorry. It was PR Rock and Daigo was the first. We used single elimination back then.
Oh, okay.
It was the first battle of the top eight, which people thought wasn't very fair, but it's the way wasn't. The luck of the draw. Ryan did take him out, and we all jumped on stage, and it was magical. That was one of our moments.
See, I keep track of your FGC progress.
That's cool. And then
you don't keep track of ours.
We keep track of everybody. I'm trying, Kevin. I'm trying. I'm too busy organizing tournaments, you know?
That's
not an excuse.
In between organizing tournaments.
I'm sleeping.
From the train ride from London to Birmingham to Telford.
All right, I'm going
to
put you out there. I drive.
Then you should listen to BBC Radio. Do you?
You kind of lose it a bit. It changes frequency as the further north you go.
Concrosion.
I've got every counter for every question you're going to vote. Bring it on.
Concrosion and Metallic
Mike. Metallic Mike is, again, another visible player over here. Got a bit of a mouth in him. He's very confident.
Is he an android in real life? Does he have any metallic stuff in him?
Or is he anything to do with the new movie of the same name? But I know he plays King of Fighters. I know he plays Street Fighter. So I haven't seen him in Cross Tekken. So
yeah, I've been disqualified from Street Fighter because I'm here commentating right now. But I'm glad that Z has made it really, really far, and I hope he makes it. I wanted him to get a qualifying spot.
We'll see, but there are a few contenders. So good luck to everyone. May the best man win.
Well, he needs to win Chairithi. I think the main contenders is Chairithi, Reinhardt. I think Reinhardt will have to face Chairithi later.
It would have been Fuzzy, but he already qualified in Paris. Yes. He's probably our strongest player.
Yeah.
Cross Tekken.
And then there's Z and... Does F word play?
No. Nobuki's so different, isn't she? So
okay.
For example, but
who else plays? Problem X? Andreas?
No, it don't bother.
All right, man. Loads of them don't. He just needs to win Reinhardt and Chairithi.
Listen to the name. I'm still the daddy. Yeah, he's got name for a reason.
Who?
He's a guy called I'm Still the Daddy. Yeah,
but that's on the lower bracket because Z is already on the top bracket.
Oh, right.
So he has to go through Reinhardt anyway.
Oh, I haven't seen the bracket recently, so...
But, you know, from the flow of the game, you kind of know who's in the bottom and top because they play the top first.
I wasn't watching it.
Yeah, so Momochi already played with Z, so Z is already down.
All right, down.
Yeah, quite far ahead.
Ryan was further down in the bracket.
Yeah, and
so,
Ryan just started playing, I think. And Chairithi also just started playing, so I think... Z doesn't need to meet that guy, whoever
okay.
he is.
Okay.
So anyway. I hope that Z... Let's see the
here he goes,
OTG.
Yeah. You know what? Yeah, now I remember Kalik Mike. He uses Jury in Street Fighter 4.
Well, he's really good. He's really
and
good.
He's from...
look at that.
Wow.
Now, that's how Jury is played.
Jury is, you know, when she's used correct, so it's wonderful to watch.
And Corrosion, being Zangief, the man, does not tag out when he had the chance. And now he's dead.
Come on, man. It's not Marvel.
But he won the first game. Oh, time over.
Yeah, he did, didn't he?
It's kind of strange. One round each.
Here we go. Is that unknown tech from Elisa?
She looks like Gouken firing those fireballs.
Yeah, definitely.
Those mini rockets. Corrosion right now just trying to zone out Zangief.
Wow, nice combos. It's a launch. See what Lisa can do.
Oh, nice.
Wow, backed out the corner.
So much help. I think...
Oh, good switch.
I think he should really change Rolento in. Zangief is
struggling with all these fireball characters.
Oh, almost a happy birthday there.
What's he doing? Oh,
switch it out.
Just push the buttons, man. Wow, this guy, he really wants to fight. I give him that much, yeah.
This is so unnecessary.
Switch now. Thank you.
That was so unnecessary.
So you know, the Simpson, you're literally screaming at the screen. Switch!
Oh, do it! Don't take it!
What are you bringing him back in for?
What are you doing?
All right. I'm going to give him a round of applause for that. Calculated risk.
Oh, that was exciting.
Okay, straight back in. Is that Elisa trying to keep... You know what, I think...
Z's in top 8 for Street Fighter Cross Tekken. This is top 8 right now. You guys are playing
Cross Tekken. You're right about the Goku reference. Like, you know, you end up jumping against the fireball. You don't want to.
Yeah, he should definitely switch out. Because Rolento is a better matchup for both these characters. For Jury and Elisa. And Zangief is just being... pounded by all these anti-airs and fireballs. It's really not... He should just use Zangief in as a damage.
Yeah, just raw power.
Raw power.
Ooh, nice counter hit.
And have Rolento be the launcher. Ooh, doesn't punish there. Ooh!
So I think sometimes they just...
too scared to press buttons.
The blocking is just like... Just sort of close your eyes and hope. Because it's still... You don't know where Tekken characters are going high and low.
Yeah.
Good blocking.
I think Conrosion doesn't know the matchup pretty well. He doesn't seem to punish a lot of Elisa moves.
No, none of us in this country know how to fight Elisa.
That's true.
We don't.
I have no idea.
No, I think
but it looks like a lot of things are punishable, by the way.
I think just, you know, in this scenario, would you take a low hit? I'd just probably duck a lot. I don't think.
Oh, nice!
No conversion. Big damage from Zangief.
Oh, tries.
Could have gone for a smash.
Back dash.
But he jumped back.
Roll for it. Oh, nice!
Green hand.
Green hand. Oh no, green hand. He's gonna have a huge problem
look at
getting
the length
in.
On those. I don't know if it's a poker or a special move or what.
I think that's
good launch
that's
combo
round for Metallic Mike.
That's a strong first round for Mike. Gets a bit impatient. I think he could zone Zangief out a lot more with those fireballs, but I think he's supposed to get in there and get the job done.
Yep,
possibly.
Right.
Good blocking.
Ooh, nice jab.
Wow. Stayed in front.
But that wasn't going to be a bag.
Why didn't he just block then?
Maybe he was trying to anti-air or do something.
Oh, I don't know.
I think he was trying to do something there because that was just right in the face.
That's why I can't think. Maybe what he was saying, God knows.
All right. I don't think he's using the right tools for Rolento to really get in on the fireball, but he gets the launcher anyway. Ooh,
well, I was waiting for the roll.
Great punish there.
Good launch. Oh, single hard kick. Get the job done, I suppose. Nice in combo. Straight into Jury. Ground bounce. I don't know. I think maybe he's anticipating a roll, but I'd stay up in his face with Jury.
Yeah, I think if I'm Conqueror right now, I think he should either do a cross assault or, you know, find some way to land a super. But I think he should really do a cross assault right now before time runs out.
You know, a lot of players don't understand the benefits of doing that sometimes. They don't. They just think, oh, two characters on the screen. They forget that the energy gets distributed evenly, don't they?
And if he did that right now, he would have survived this attack and be on the upper hand because you have two characters rushing down on Jury.
Yeah.
But now Metallic Mike has evened it up 1-1. See, now he ended that round with full meter, and there's just no reason for that to happen.
It's like, don't take it with you, you know, just use it, get rid of it.
Yeah. Especially at that point where, you know, it's really hard for him to win, he's making a comeback, his life is really low. Ooh, nice chop!
I saw that coming, you know.
Grab him! SPD!
Look at those blades!
Ooh, can nice be all. Anti-air. Those can be all plus on frames. Wow, a good launcher there.
Not sure what happened there. Oh, nice neutral jump.
No,
into Alisa.
Does well to change, but a little too late. She done it faster. Oh, nice. Corrosion's just trying to fish for a launcher right now. But not being able to punish any of Elisa's moves is going to be a huge problem for Corrosion. He should at least try.
Wow, two of those. That works.
Oh, nice block.
Corner pressure from Jury. Lovely boost combo launch.
Yeah, I think that's it for this round. Metallic Mike's got us.
Wow.
I mean, yeah.
You could have some sort of odd frame trap or just... Where's the gap in that, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, good start. Wow. Stylish, I like that.
Yeah, that's so dangerous.
Oh
nice block there.
Jesus, I'm not quite sure what happened there. Maybe.
Yeah, he just walked right into the kick.
Yeah.
It's kind of strange. Has Conqueror given up on this man?
Okay.
Yes, wow. Yes, I think.
I'll still give it tournament nerves, but definitely Mike's got the pace going now.
No cross up there, just a jump leg punch. A nice slide. Ooh, nice! Oh, feels converted.
Mike's really relaxed now. Hopefully he won't start doing a few tricks. I don't think I'm not gonna work.
He needs to make something happen right now because there's 50 seconds left and you know.
There's not much.
Metallic Mike has a huge life lead. And still all the gems unactivated.
Wow, I do like that combo. Change Jury.
Well, he's not even tagging anymore.
Wow.
Yeah.
Not sure all right,
I guess Conqueror just wanted to end the match right there.
That's a shame because, you know, this game does encourage you to, you know, to attack. So, I don't know, maybe just lost confidence.
Yes.
You know, never give up, you know.
Yes.
Some of the best comebacks, well, this game doesn't really allow it, but some of the best comebacks in the world is when you're down, you know, and you're almost out. Ryan Hart's good at that. You know what I mean? Like,
yes.
Sort of, he's got no energy. He turns on the ignition and boom, he's off.
Yep. All right, right now it's Chiriithi and Momochi on winner's semis. So the winner of this match will go meet Ryan Hart and Metallic Mike. The winner of Metallic Mike and Ryan Hart for winner's finals.
That's funny because it's, Mike's beaten beat Ryan in Street Fighter 4 tournament. So that'd be an interesting rivalry. See how that transcribes this game, you know.
I think Metallic Mike will have a good chance against Ryan, but I've never seen Ryan play Street Fighter Quest Tekken yet.
You have haven't?
No, I haven't.
Oh no, he's one of our he's just got it down, he's got a, you know,
well,
a handful of
Ryan Hart is good at every game anyway. You don't have to say one of our best players.
No, but he really does shine. He's really creative in this game. He's not, you know, he's got different characters, different characters in his pocket. You know, I'm not sure he's using Ryu, Raven, Hugo.
For all the guys watching the stream, Capcom Fighters, please subscribe, hit the follow button to support Capcom, who has through this wonderful tournament for everybody. The follow button should be around here. Just hit it so that whenever the Capcom Fighters go live, everyone will be notified via email. And, you know, I think the finals is going to be really, really exciting.
Yeah, very exciting.
In San Francisco. And everybody should just subscribe to it, follow the Twitch site, and hopefully, you know, be able to make some time out of your busy schedule. Actually, take a day off. It's on the 8th of December.
Yeah.
Everybody's going to be there. Daigo.
Isn't 8th a Saturday?
Infiltration is a Saturday.
Saturday, so.
Yep. Some people work on Saturday mornings.
They do.
Half days.
You're right.
Some people need to work on Saturdays. But do take the day off. If you're in San Francisco, be sure to go down to the event. I don't know if it's an open event. I think it is because Capcom has been so generous for this amazing tournament. I'm really, really excited. It's free entry for all. Is there free drinks? Pizza?
Oh, that's cool.
All right, everybody, I just got word that if you go down to Capcom Unity, there is information about attending the 25th event. There's free, not sure about free drinks, but there's definitely
really
a goodie bag, free goodie bag for the first 1,000 people.
Never stipulate the free drink part because
it's not alcoholic drinks.
Oh, it's right. This is
like maybe water.
Soft drinks.
Yeah, so you don't get dehydrated.
Very good point.
Yes.
There's
definitely free water everywhere.
I got confused. I apologize.
And, Momochi, starting off really well again with those footsies.
Oh, good cross
and up. And Chiriithi using Claw, which is also another good footsie character. But I'm just surprised he used Rufus first.
Ooh, that was...
And it's a perfect for Momochi. Really fast.
7 gold letters.
Wow, a great anti-air there. Hi. Wow, another great... Everything starts with the down light kick for Momochi right now. Ooh, nice.
Let's see what he's got.
Momochi trying to catch the roll.
Oh!
Wow.
I love that.
That's it.
That neutral hard punch creates a ground bounce.
This is what I'm talking about.
Something quite nasty.
Max combos, max damage, 71 seconds.
That's
1P and 1S.
That's 3-5 per second. You can't say it's you know, slow-paced and dull. Come on, guys.
Yes. If this is the way to play the game, Momochi showing everybody how it's done. Ooh, nice.
Nice start. Yeah, I don't know. I haven't got much.
That down light kick from Cody is just ridiculous, giving
Chiriithi
nice so much problems. Just mashing that light kick.
Science the corner. Oh, nice switch. Wow, crossed over twice.
Oh, almost felt the end for Chariti there. Almost got a happy birthday to end the game. Drops the combo. Momochi still applying so much pressure on Chariti. Not really being able to let him like pick up his own, play his own game.
I can see that. Oh, come on, he must be nervous.
And this what happens when, you know, Momochi is rushing down so much, Chariti is just not in the same state of mind.
No, so when he does get an opening, he's probably... Great use of alpha counter.
But Chariti has already qualified for third strike.
Okay.
So he's definitely going to San Francisco. He's just trying to pick up another game right now. He's a really excellent Kami player. And Street Fighter Cross Second, I think... Momochi is still too dominant right now. But this is winner's semis, so whoever goes into loser's bracket still has a huge chance to advance.
Yes.
Because top two goes to San Francisco.
At least it is top two.
Yes. Top two for this game. So
is it this and Street Fighter 4 top two?
Yes. And then the rest is just the first.
I'm interested to see SF2. Finals. There's like three guys that are. I can't tell who it would be. Yep. But we'll talk about it later anyway.
Wolfstone and Brains for Trade.
Oh, Messiah reversal.
I think Chariti has followed Z and given up, doing a full screen EX Messiah kick.
Last call for Boxhound.
Oh, that's it. Let's see. Yes, lovely from Vega. And repeats it.
Oh no.
Going for it.
A nice tag out there by Momochi. Oh, he whiffs the punish.
Oh, good block.
Oh, drops a huge combo.
What is he doing? Can't push buttons like that.
No, he got the combo. He just dropped it.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
Oh.
Nice roll forward. Delayed roll. All right, Chariti really, really needs to do something, but I think he's done. 35 seconds left. Cody with full life.
Wow,
with
there
one
it
combo,
is.
There it is. Momochi moves on to winner's finals to face the winner of Reinhardt and Fresno? Dresno? Yes, Dresno, I think.
So we'll call clean games.
Yes.
Straight to the point. I'll pick up Haunts because he's just sitting in that corner and I never realised, you know, I just didn't realise Haunts. He just powers the world, man. I thought he'd have like a, I don't know, like some guy that really, you know, like come and send him for him or something. Or he just does it all day, all by yourself. So big up to Haunts.
I always thought Haunts was a very scary guy.
Really?
But he's such a nice guy. I don't understand.
I thought he'd be taller. But I'm just not going
with that. It's like these fraudulent names to make, you know, the opposite of what people think they are. In
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But I'm looking forward for the 25th anniversary in San Francisco. A very beautiful city. Great seafood. Great food there.
Yep.
That's what I missed out. One of the best cities in the world. San Francisco.
So I have to... I've been looking forward to this, obviously, because it's in my home country. And it's great to see so many guys flying. I think it's the first time in a long time that some high-level, you know, guys from other regions have come to England. And we're honoured for that because... It takes a lot.
You got Ryan Hart.
I've got him all day long. He's boring.
You got Andreas.
Yeah, you know. Andreas hands is.
Boktanian or someone from Capcom to please set up HD Remix onto the stage.
All right.
Okay.
So we're going to take a 5-minute break. And that was the last Street Fighter Cross second match of the day. Oh, no, not of the day. But for now.
Of course, yeah.
And then we're going to come back and with Super Tobo.
Yeah, my personal favorite. Yes. It's been interesting.
The best soundtrack amongst all the soundtracks.
Yep.
Although, wait, the strike is also really good.
Yeah, they are, aren't they? So,
all right. So for today, this is the last game for Cross Tekken.
So we can see the Street Fighter 2 finals, yes. Then the Street Fighter 3.
Z made it top 8. I'm really excited. Shout outs to Desperation Move, Madcat Z. He's my boy. I'm sorry.
There you go. Yep. Big up.
All right. They're going to switch to Street Fighter Cross Tekken right... Super Tobo right now, so...
You know what? I think we'll take a little break.
Yeah, 5 minutes?
Yep. That's all cool. Right. We'll be right back, guys.